thought we'd do it on the avenue.
All right, welcome back to another episode of Suniva Lifestyles Podcast Presents What's Happening. So what's happening, fellas? Again, I'm with co-host Tim. Got my cousin Mike.
What's up, what's up?
Got little Chris.
Hello.
And we got Metal George.
Orale.
What's happening, what's happening? Hey, we had a...
What is happening? Or what did happen?
Okay, here we go. We'll just jump right into this thing like always. So,
firm believer in that.
So Mike has a 63 Impala.
Correct.
Bomb car. Had it for how many years? 40 years?
It's been in my family all my life. I started working on it when I was about 16. So I've had it, I guess technically we could say since I've been 16 and I'm 49 years old now.
You're older than that.
No, I'm not.
No, it is a dope, dope car. And we're going to do an on-location podcast at A-Bomb's Lover's Lane art show downtown Phoenix this past Friday. So we're going to do it from the car. And so Mike and I were on our way in the car. We were being followed by George and Greg.
The Bombero.
And we took a detour. We took a hard right on 15th Avenue and got in a car wreck. I got a little zipper, but we're good. We walked away from it. That's the most important thing about the whole thing. Car took a little bit of a beating.
Yeah.
But what's going to happen? What are you going to do with it, Mike?
I don't know. You know, after we assess it here, we're going to figure it out. But, you know, I took some time to consume what happened. And like you said, you know, I'm thankful that we are able to walk away. It's just a vehicle. But now I'm going to look at it as an opportunity to rebuild it.
Absolutely. Rebuild it, right?
Get back into it. It'd be a great thing for me and my boys to get back into it. And, you know, maybe it's time to upgrade, obviously, do that type of thing. But, you know, we've had a lot of great memories in that car, man. It's just a car. You know, and I apologize to you for...
No need to apologize, man. It was an honor.
Putting you in that situation. But, you know, we were headed to the event, man, and we were coming close to 15th Avenue, and we were on Van Buren. We were coming up to the light on 15th Avenue, and the light turned red, and I went to hit the brakes, and the brakes went straight to the floor. And I think I yelled to you, I go, Tim, we don't have brakes, man.
I was like, you're kidding.
Yeah, he said, are you kidding? I go, I'm not kidding. And I was pumping the brakes, and they just kept hitting the floor. So at that time, the light turned red. I had to make a split decision, and I was going to shoot the four-way stop. I was going to, and Tim said he saw, you know, cars were going across, and he's like, hey, man, we're going to get T-boned. You should hit the corner. And so as we got close, I tried to turn my car, and my car doesn't have power steering, so, you know, it takes a little effort to turn that car. And as I turned to make that corner, there was a car in the turning lane to make a left-hand turn there on 15th Avenue, and the only thing I could do was hit him. So
what was the car you hit?
It was a Toyota.
It was a truck, a little 4x4.
Yeah, it was a little Toyota Tacoma.
Yeah.
In the left-hand turning lane.
Yep.
Yep.
So we hit him. The car obviously did not stop. We got pushed to ran into somebody's yard, knocked over a fence, and actually that was kind of a blessing because we hit the curb. We jumped the curb. And I think the only thing that helped us stop was that when my back tires hit the curb, it kind of stopped and threw us forward. I turned the car off. I jumped out because I wanted to make sure that the person that I hit was okay, more so than I was. I knew that I was okay. I did bang up my knee a little bit, but as I ran to the guy first to see if he was okay, and he kind of nodded that he was okay. And as I came back to the car, Tim was, you know, kind of laying in the seat, in the front seat, and he had his hand over his head and he was bleeding. So then I was really concerned for Tim, and he was like, man, I'm bleeding. And everybody started screaming, you know, he needs a towel. And I had towels obviously in the trunk. So I popped the trunk. At that time, now people came out of their houses. We had a bunch of people out there that were genuinely concerned.
Yeah, good Samaritans.
That Tim was okay. Gave Tim a towel. Somebody asked, should we call 911? I said, yes, absolutely. They called 911. At that point, then I called Angela, let her know that I was in an accident. And then the paramedics came, and the firefighter came.
They were right down the street. Yep. They were right there.
Yep.
Yeah, they were there pretty quick.
Sure,
they were
pretty quick. I mean, they're literally right there.
Wow. Yeah, because I turned around, they were there.
You had your personal firefighters.
Yeah, then we had Greg, the personal firefighter there.
The next door neighbor, one of the guys that came out and checked on you was a Scottsdale fireman.
Yes, he was the first one to start talking to me. I don't know his name. Hey, man, thank you. Right on, appreciate it.
Timmy, but you're okay, right?
Yeah, no, it should. I'm good, man. I got no complaints. Everything worked out.
Vince, you're okay.
I'm okay. I just banged up my knee, but Tim did go to the hospital and, had a slight concussion and got some stitches in his forehead.
Remembered some shit I haven't remembered in years after that bump in the head.
It could have been worse, though. What I see, man, you guys, it could have been worse.
Yeah, man. Thank the Lord, man. Everything worked out.
I don't, yeah.
Yeah. You know, in hindsight, you're absolutely right. Things could have been worse as I started to think about it. That's a high foot traffic area. You know, I could have hit a pedestrian. Man. Apparently the house that I ran the fence over and into the yard, they were telling us that the little girls that live there play outside a lot.
See, it could have been worse.
And it could have been worse. They could have been outside. And
yeah, they had their little slides and stuff out there in the yard.
Yeah.
So, it worked. I mean,
yeah.
For a bad situation, it turned out, probably best it could have. So we're blessed and happy.
I got a couple questions, but I got a couple statements too. That car, man, it's just not a car. You know, like you said, you've been working on it since 16. That's a lot of my memories. Majority of my years are in that car.
Yeah.
That car's dope. It's a West Side legend. We were talking about it me and one of the homies, and he's like, man, that car, you know what I mean? You drive down Roosevelt, that car. You go down Central, that car. McDowell, that car.
Yeah.
So that's a lot of my memories too in it. And my brother, we've always cruised in it with Vince, and we've always had good times. And dope car, good memories.
Yeah.
My question is, we all live off of McDowell. What were you doing on Van Buren? You could have went down McDowell to Grand and Grand. Easy, bro. There's no time. Grand's wide open. It was easy. What were you guys doing on Van Buren?
I don't know. Here's the other thing. Thank God that, as Tim took an Uber to my house, we got in my car. And the ironic thing about it is when Tim got in my car, he actually said, hey, okay, so my car is old. It didn't come with car seats.
No, seatbelts.
Seatbelts. I'm sorry. Yeah, seatbelts.
Car seats.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Timmy would have benefited from it if we had
a car seat. I wish it had car seats.
I had to put Tim in the car seat. Yeah.
No.
No, you're right. Yeah. I bet seatbelts. But when my kids were younger and they wanted to start cruising with me, I put seatbelts only in the back seat for them.
Understand.
And I put them in them myself, right, for them, for their safety. And they were really just lap belts. But when Tim got to my house and we got in my car, he was like, hey, man, your damn car doesn't have any seatbelts.
God dang.
And I
jinxed it.
And I go, we've never had seatbelts.
Tim, we've never said that when we jumped in the car.
Dude, I've
16 years old on up. We've never said that. All of a sudden, you said,
dude, you know what? It's been a long time since I've been in that car. And I jumped in, and the first thing I looked around, I was like, shit, where's the seatbelts at?
Yeah. Who do you work for?
Safety first, man.
You're not in compliance.
Yeah. So we had my son Desi with us, and I was taking him to drop him off at my mom's, and I thank the Lord also that Desi didn't decide to go with me that early to the event, to Lover's Lane, and I dropped him off, and just thank God that he wasn't in the car, because when we had the impact, Tim wasn't wearing a seatbelt, so he flew up. He flew up in the air.
Yeah.
And that's why he hit the top of the windshield. And
yeah. Hit the crossbar.
He hit the crossbar.
The window, yeah. The windshield frame.
Yeah. Mm.
So, no, it worked out, man. It worked out. But I agree with what Chris said. Car's a legend, man. You got to fix it. Got to get it back on the road. I'll cruise with you again.
Yeah. 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 I've had
this time the car seat.
This time put a car seat in it.
Actually, you know what? I cruised with that with the boys when they were younger in a car seat. Yeah. I've had them in a car seat. Plenty of times. It's just a car, but just got to reassess everything. And now, like I said, it's an opportunity to rebuild and move forward and make it a new car.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah.
You got my help, man. Whatever you need done, you need to tear it down. If you need, whatever you need, I'll be right there. I'll help you tear it down and put it back together, man.
And speaking of that, it was comforting and I'm very grateful with everybody that reached out to me and actually even... with that, hey man, whatever you need help, people were already dropping me names of who could help, who has what, people were even telling me like, hey man, I'll pitch in money to help you fix that car.
And whatever you need.
Yeah, no doubt.
I'm very thankful for that because I didn't realize that, you know, I had that much love out there for that.
No,
type of thing. It was cool.
A lot of love, man. And I agree. That car's got to get back on the road.
Yeah, I received so many texts of people like, hey, bro, I just heard what happened. Sorry about that, but it's all good. You know, luckily we're good.
Yeah, we're good. We're good.
And then you guys were following us, you know, like, so what was going through your head?
What'd you see?
When you were behind us?
I was like, that should have been me in the passenger seat. Because usually that is me.
Yeah.
And everybody was like, were you in the car? And I'm like, no, I was Timmy. And I was supposed to be in that seat that day.
I was supposed to Uber.
And you were supposed to Uber. And Greg actually, Greg the Bombero, who we've had on the show before, he actually offered to pick me up so we could take all the equipment to where we're going, to Adam's Lover's Lane art show. And so he's actually, where's Vince at? I go, he's already ahead of us. Let's go catch up to him. So, okay, we caught up to you guys right here in front of your mom's house. You had just dropped off Desi. And then all of a sudden you start cruising. We go to Van Buren and we're going down Van Buren. And I'm like, to me, that I'm going, yeah, he's going the right way, actually. I'm thinking that. And you're never thinking the brakes are going to give out or anything's going to give out like that. You're just driving, you know. And then all of a sudden we come up to, we're coming up to 15. I mean, we probably jinxed it too because me and Greg are like, here's a quick little story. We're driving, right? We're coming down the road. We're coming down McDowell. We're trying to catch up to you. And there's a chick in yoga pants with her dog. And she's bent over picking up probably his shit. And we're like, Telemundo. And we're both looking at each other. We're going to have a good day today. Greg says it out loud. We're going to have a good day today. We're like, pick her up. She's here, Chikey. Anyways, we keep going. We catch up to you. We get up to like where you're coming. And we finally catch up to you. And you're like right there at coming up to 15th Avenue. And the next thing you know, we're just talking. Actually, we're talking about your peepa in the back, how it's dangling. And we're like, oh, we need to fix that. And it's just going like that. And the next thing you know, I'm like, where the fuck is he going? Because you made this hard right.
Damn.
Yeah.
You made a hard right. And I'm like, where the fuck is he? I just said, where the fuck is he going? And Greg goes, And he says this. He goes, he has no brakes. And then, boom, you hit that fucking Toyota.
Yeah.
And I couldn't see you now because there was like a gate right there on 15th Avenue. And I couldn't see, but Greg could see from where his vantage point was. He hit it. And what's crazy is it's still not registering. He just got in a fucking wreck. It's not clicking in my head. And then all of a sudden, Greg goes, I don't see Timmy. I think he's fucking hurt.
Yeah, because he slid down.
And then, because I seen you pulling the wheel. I seen you trying to pull that wheel. And then I seen Timmy grab that crossbar, and then he grabbed the seat. And then I seen him grab everything like that. And then all of a sudden, I didn't see anything anymore. And then Greg goes, I think he's hurt. I don't see Timmy. And we got stuck behind a car at the light, and that light took, it seemed like that light took forever to change.
Yeah.
And finally, we get around the corner, and then you already had given him the towel, and he's sitting on the, and I'm like, oh, I see the blood. I'm like, ah, oh, but then I hear him say, no, I'm all right. He's telling somebody he's all right.
Cool, good.
And, but he's, pobrecito, little Timmy's little, he's little, you know, he's crouched up in the front seat, like a little, you know how your little baby sits? Yeah. Like,
I just need to lay down for a minute.
And I'm like, fucking, I'm like, yeah. Michael, you didn't do a stop short?
Yeah, I didn't stop
short. You know, you didn't stop short like that. You know, you do that to your kid, you know.
Yeah.
Or to the chick when she's, you know, in the passenger seat.
That's funny because that's exactly what I told Dan. It's like, oh, I should have stopped short.
Yeah, I wish you would have. Yeah.
But, you know, it's because the car doesn't have power steering.
Sure.
Yeah. You know, if it had, then you could stop short. But I had to use two hands to turn.
You know, and then you're like, the brakes, man, they went all the way to the floor. And like, man, didn't they have a recall on those brakes? Man? Could have took it back. You know?
Shit, I wish.
It's 64. Yeah.
That's a strange feeling to know when you push the brake and it hits the floor.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like something no other.
Well, the other guy was all right, too, right?
Yeah. Thank God. Yes. Everybody was okay. That's good. Thank God.
That was the one thing that people were saying that came out to help. They're like, usually there's a lot of homeless people right there, and they're actually a lot of traffic. And sure enough, when we're standing there, there's people going by left and right. Like, man, you hit it. You know, it's bad, but you came at the right time.
It was the best situation.
Yeah,
and you didn't hit the car that was parked.
Yeah,
could have been worse.
Right, there was a car that was parked right in front of the house, and I avoided that car by
inches.
And I saw it too, and I didn't want to hit that car either.
But he did take out the recycle bin, though. What do you say about that?
We'll take him a new one on Monday. We'll take care of that. No, you know what? This dude calls me too, and he's like, man, Vince just got into a wreck. The car's done. I go, what the? Oh, shit. And I just got out of work maybe an hour prior.
What is it? They're sleeping.
Friday. You know, Fridays usually I'm tired. So I was laying down, and I said, you know what? Starts at 6. I got some time. Chill out. And I was nodding out. My lady was nodding out. Next you know, he calls me, he tells me that. And then we hang up, and then I think about it. I'm like, you know what? These dudes might need some backup. You know, old school shit. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So I'm like, get your shit on, girl. Let's go. She's like, what? She heard the talk. She's like, what? Are they all right? She's just getting, let's go. And I don't know. He said Van Buren, but then I was thinking, I went down Van Buren, but I go, like, they have no business on Van Buren. And I didn't see like the
hookers, fire engine,
nothing. And I'm like, well, you know what? We're coming up to 15th. I'll just make my left and go to McDowell because I thought. And then I seen you guys over there. And when I busted up, you know, the right, I looked. By that time, your whole family was there. And that was cool. That was good. Everything looked under control. And I was like, all right, cool. You know what I mean? And my mind eased right there. But usually, you know, when a wreck happens like that, people get out there hostile. Nah.
Yeah, he was lucky.
We're not going to let you go out like that.
You know, and I apologized to him. You know, I was like, hey, bro, you know, my intention, I would never hit you like that, but I couldn't control my car.
He was a little paisa. He understood what you're saying, but he couldn't relay it back to you and say, you know, I understand. You know,
right.
It took a couple that were there that kind of relayed that to you and said, you know, he understands what.
Yeah.
He understands it wasn't your fault.
Yeah, it was an accident.
It was an accident.
Accidents do happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A real legit accidents do happen.
But he did start limping at the end there.
He started hearing all those commercials in his head. El choque.
I did notice that. You're right.
Yeah.
He started limping. Yeah.
For airbag.
Timmy told the Scottsdale fire guy, there's no seatbelts.
He goes, do you have a seatbelt on? There is no seatbelt.
He just shook his head. Yeah. And then my first call was to Angela, and, you know, I didn't want to put her in panic mode. So I just kind of said, hey, everything's okay. It was just an accident. And then, you know, I was nervous, and I told her I was on 19th Avenue in
Vancouver. Yeah.
I'm on McDowell.
Who called Timmy's lady?
I called her from the emergency room.
Yeah, I remember don't call her.
Yeah, I told everybody, don't call her, man. Don't call her. I'll call her when I'm ready.
If I can walk there, let me see if I can wipe the blood off it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, even that, like Timmy's phone was by my feet.
Yeah, dude, I was like, where's my, I got out. I was like, where's my phone at?
Yeah, he's like,
my phone? Well, if you, I mean, maybe we'll post it, but there's a picture of the glove box. Timmy's knee went through the glove box. He put a big dent in that.
Yeah, you know, it's surprisingly enough.
And it's all metal.
Your right knee, your left knee, or your wee knee?
Wee knee.
Next question. You didn't have the sweats on, huh?
Yeah, I had sweats on.
Little tripod.
Like, I was thinking you, babe.
I
was thinking
you. Yeah. I
put my hands like this and hit it.
He hip thrusted.
No, it worked out, man. It worked out. It worked out. I really did. And
I got to give a lot to Greg, man. He helped out. He put you in his truck and
he took
you over to St.
Greg, thank you, man. Right. Yeah. I appreciate
Phoenix
it.
Phoenix is finest.
Phoenix is finest.
Yeah, then we get to Burns Room. He goes, do you want me to go in with you? I go, sure. He goes, really?
I'm just kidding. Dropped you off at the curb.
Yeah, the curb.
Because when I went over there, he was back already. I was like,
you want to? He goes, really?
Did he carry Tim to his truck?
It looked like it, yeah.
Yeah.
He didn't even open the door for me.
He was like that.
I think he carried, picked him out of my car.
What hospital did you go to?
Yeah.
St. Joe's, you know what, man? And
Neurological Center.
Muhammad Ali, they threw you in the Muhammad Ali ward.
You know what, man? I'll give a shout out to St. Joe's, man. I dread going to the emergency room. And I got there early enough, and they walked me through it pretty quick for the emergency.
You said they text you now.
Yeah, they text you, kind of give you a heads up where you are in line. And then they sent me a text that said...
Your food's ready.
Yeah. Your burger's ready. Something like diagnostic test has been ordered for you, whatever. Blah, blah, blah. And then That was a CAT scan. So they came, got me, took me back. So shout out to them, man. They did a good job.
I haven't been to an emergency room in a long time, so I didn't know they do that to your phone.
Dude, usually
I didn't know they do that now.
Yeah, usually you get to emergency room, you're there for hours, man.
Tell them what happened when you got out. There was
Okay. So we crashed about 3 o'clock. So I checked in at 3:33 because that's the first text I got. And then so I got out there about 7:30, 8 o'clock, and that emergency room was
you could have made it. You would have been a legend over there. We would throw you on our shoulders and walk around.
Dude, I was just close. I said, "Should we go?" I was like, "I got a headache, man. I ain't going."
Yeah,
that's understandable.
Yeah.
So, but no, it was good, man. So shout to St. Joe's. Did a good job. I'll give him that.
Cool. Yeah. You got any follow ups coming?
No,
take the stitches out.
I got to take stitches out, but I think I do it myself. I'm not going back for that.
Put a bolt in it. It looked dope.
Put two bolts on your neck.
Timmenstein. Nah, it worked out, man. It worked out.
I'm glad you're okay.
Yeah, we're all glad you're okay, man.
I apologize.
Really do. We really are.
No, it was good, man. It was good. You know what? I wish I could have went to the show because I saw the pictures online. That shit looked dope.
We weren't at the show yet.
I know,
but the show's happening in a little while right now. After this. After we talk about this.
Yeah, concussion protocol.
And you know what, Vince? He took it pretty well, too. He looked like he was... You look like you were having a good time, and you know what I mean, considering what happened. But man, like I said, man, that car's a legend. It is a legend. I don't know if you know that. You have to know that.
Yeah, no, let me tell you real quick. This real quick. So we're there. We're standing there with him, and waiting for the tow truck to get there. And it kept giving him an update. Hey, we'll be on our way. And then this guy turns to me and goes, "You guys should go."
Yeah,
you guys should go to do the show. And I wasn't even thinking that.
Right.
Because he had asked, "What do you guys want to do?" And I'm like, "I want to take a shot right now, a couple shots. Get this out of my fucking head."
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he goes, "No, go set up. Go do it." And I'm like, because I already had text. I had texted Adam and said, "Hey, man, we're not going to make it. He's like, "Cool. Yeah, understand." He understood and all that, which was cool.
Right.
And then the next thing you know, I'm texting Adam, "Hey, Danny LaRusso's gonna go. He's gonna fight."
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. The show must
come
go
out.
On,
yeah, then come on and hobble out.
Yeah.
Yeah. But Mr. Miyagi.
Yes.
Dirty Cortez and all.
Yeah.
And he did you go on the change?
No.
Oh shit.
And he tells me, "Hey, get all the camera equipment in the trunk and put it in the back of Greg's truck." And me and Greg were like, "Yeah, we still got to go get beer ourselves, you know." You know, yeah. And that's what we did. We set up. And, you know, I got to give a huge shout out to the homeboy Carlos, Sophisticated Few, coming through.
Yes.
With his ride. Real huge thank you to Carlos for doing that, man. I mean.
Did you know he was on his way away?
And to let us do it from inside his ride. I mean, his ride is so
pristine. Yeah, it's a nice car. And for people to get in and out of that thing is greatly appreciated.
Yeah.
And not the only thing was he originally wasn't going in his car.
Right.
He was going in his regular car.
I called him. He goes, "I'm already left my house. I'm in my regular car." I go, and then he asked me, do you need me to bring it? I go, "That's up to you." And we kept going back and forth. That's no, cool. You, no, you, no, you. And I go, "Hey, it's up to you." And next thing you know, he calls me back. "Hey, I'll be there in 15 minutes with the ride." I'm like,
yeah, that was really cool, yeah, man.
I feel bad because when I got in it, I made it even lower than it was. God damn it, man, I couldn't get out. It was like
struggle city.
Yeah, it was like getting in and out of a Porsche.
You didn't fit in the car seat.
Went from a dope car to a dope car.
So mm-hmm. Yeah, cool. It was really nice. I appreciate, you know, you guys all hanging out there with me, you know, guys sticking around and I felt kind of bad, like, damn, man, I just put a damper on the whole evening and the whole night. So that's why I was like, no, man, you guys go ahead and go do it and go get it. And, you know, I was obviously concerned for Tim, but just my knee was hurting. But I knew that I was going to eventually maybe try and at least go.
No,
and you did.
Yeah. That's good, man. It worked out. Everything worked out. You know, and now we got a story.
Now we got a story,
right? So yeah, it worked out.
And now you're... number one love now is back to your old lady now. It used to be the car. And now it's your old lady again. Back. Yeah,
she's back in first place. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Hey, so...
She had a couple of wire cutters for the brake lines. I seen that.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, shit. I didn't think about that. Makes sense now. Makes sense.
Yeah. Oh, you're going without me?
Yeah. Oh, you going to take Tim?
Yeah.
No, hey, man. So... Real quick, what does your wife say about getting the car back together?
She's all 1,000%
at her girl.
As a matter of fact, I'm the one who's saying, like, maybe we should, it's time, you know, let it go.
Get a minivan.
And she's like, absolutely not. You're never going to, you're not getting rid of that car.
Excellent.
She says, you're going to fix it up. You're going to, you'll be back out there.
Good woman.
Which is greatly appreciated. Yep, yes. For
How
sure.
How come it happened exactly when the unpaid intern is supposed to take over it pretty soon?
Yeah, I don't know. And actually, you know what? That's what I was, JoJo had texted me too, and I said, hey man, this was the car that we were supposed to cruise in when we were younger, and now as older guys, we were still supposed to be cruising in that car, so I'm going to make that happen.
Nice, Mike.
Yeah.
Nice. I can't wait.
Yep. Well, I got bring shotgun. It out, man. I got shotgun. T-Dog is always complaining that you don't bring it out enough, man. So, man, when we get it back on the road, and I'm serious when we say that, when we help you get it back on your own, and we are going to do that with you, man.
Yep.
We're going to help you get it back on the road. When we do that, man, get it back out on the road.
Yeah, it's going to be back out on the road. It's going to be my goal is to make it now a new car and an old chassis.
With some seatbelts in the front.
With seatbelts in the front. Airbags.
Yeah. No arguing for me.
I know, because it would have saved his face if that airbag would have. Look at that.
Yeah, I know.
The doctors couldn't do nothing with that.
Huh? Look like Michael Jackson.
Lighter skin.
Yeah. Lighter shade of brown.
Well, that's one thing, you know, Tim's in the insurance business, car insurance business, and, you know, I'm sure he knows some things to do. And I was telling Hans, like, oh, I'm sure Tim's over there racking up the bill knowing that my insurance is going to pay. Yeah. He's probably ordering pudding.
I got no shit in my closet to have my own urgent care.
Said he wants to take home extra gauze. You know, I need gloves.
I got a mini urgent care in my closet.
Yeah, so
no,
that's what it is, man.
So just a little sore, huh, Timmy? You're a little sore.
That's it, man. Yesterday was a little foggy, but you know, I'm good.
It's like the next day coming back from the nest.
Like, yeah, the morning after.
Yeah,
but no, it's good, man. It worked out, Mike. It worked out, bro.
It worked out.
It worked out.
Yeah, you know, like plenty of memories in that car, man. We've had a lot of.
We got a couple more.
We've been in a lot of situations in that car.
Yeah. A lot of good times. A lot of good times.
I think actually there was more good times in the situations we've been caught in.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
By far. Yeah. Yeah, those situations.
Especially when it was parked in the garage out here. Yeah.
And actually, a lot of people know, even before we even had the car fixed when we were younger, we made a movie.
Yes, we did. Scarface, part two.
we made a movie.
A drug movie.
A drug movie in that car.
Yes, we did.
Before it was fixed up. I wish we could find footage of that.
Pew, pew.
It would be hilarious.
Yeah. It didn't roll, nothing.
It had a tarp over it.
Who was it?
Yeah.
Yeah, who's in it?
Us three.
Me and JoJo.
The Three Stooges. People.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was a Three Stooges
movie. We had lightsabers and Chewbacca was there.
And actually, you know, I probably still have that footage and I wish I could find it, but yeah, I'm sure it's hilarious.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. But
yeah,
that's what it
we'll
is.
We'll take it.
Yeah. So that was March 1st, first Friday, 2024.
In the year of our Lord.
Yeah.
No, it was good, man. It worked out. But hey
but
go ahead, go ahead, go ahead.
But the event was a great event.
Yeah.
I had a great time. We've seen a lot of people that I actually haven't seen in a long time.
That was a good event for that. Yeah.
Yep. Like you said, it was a lot of people that we do know. It felt very comfortable.
It was good shit.
It was good shit. Yeah.
Good shit.
Yeah.
Good shit. We had some and you'll see coming up, you'll see who we interviewed. I think we did a pretty good job for doing kind of like our second time we do it on location.
Yeah.
But this was actually out there, not something, you know.
Yeah, and then you guys scrambled, right? I mean, you had to find people. Right. So yeah, I heard you guys did a great job, Chris. I know you set in. Thank you very much.
And shout out to Greg again, man, because he helped a lot with
Shout out to Greg, the Bombero, Gmo, the future mayor of Phoenix, all of that. Yes. And he stuck it out to the end and he even helped me out
at the
getting home, unloading the stuff, man. And he had to go to work the next morning. And I'm going to get him lunch and Carlos too. I'm going to get you some lunch.
Right. We are from the podcast.
We're definitely
something.
Or something, you know. We'll get you something. But huge shout out to those two, man, for helping out, you know. And everybody else too.
Yeah.
Not
yeah.
just them, you know?
Yep.
Nope. That's good, man. That's good.
So, man, why don't you walk us out?
Yeah.
Me?
Yep.
You the man.
Hey, Timmy. Hey, man. Glad you're all right, man.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming through. Thanks for putting this together. You know, thanks to our studio audience.
Yeah.
You know who are here.
Peanut
but
Gary.
You know what? Enjoy what's going to go on right here. It's Suniva Lifestyle Presents What's Happening at the Lover's Lane Art Show, put on by A-Bomb, the artist. Check it out. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. What's happening? What's happening? Well, here we are. Suniva Lifestyles Presents What's Happening. We're in the ride today. We're in the Chicano ride share. Mañana ride share. If we don't pick you up today, we'll pick you up tomorrow.
Mañana. Hey, mañana, wey.
So here we are at the Lover's Lane Art Show today. And I got our special guest, the guy who's putting all this together. I got A-Bomb, Adam V. Hill, right here in the house.
A-Bomb's in the house.
Yes, sir. How you guys doing tonight?
Doing all right, man. How about you?
I'm doing good. Hey, first of all, I want to say I've been praying for you guys. I heard about the accident that happened today with Vince and wrecked his fucking lowrider, bro. And I'm sorry that it happened coming to my event. But you know what? You're in my prayers. Everybody that was in the accident, Timmy, everybody else. And I'm just thankful that you guys showed up and continue to do the podcast. That's what I love about our cultura, bro. We persevere. We work through the hard times, bro. So thank you.
Right on, man. Yeah, man.
You know what? Let me touch on that car a little bit, man.
Yes,
that car is like it's a West Side legend. It's West Side memories. Everybody you talk to, that car. Yes. That car's a shit, you know. My memories, teenage angel days, teenage love.
Hell yeah.
Don't hurt me again.
Thanks for that sentiments, man. Thank you for
very much. Yes, sir, man. God first.
Hey, Adam, real quick, before we get into Lover's Lane today, I want to talk about what happened last week with the Phoenix Suns. You had a collaboration with the Phoenix Suns, man. How'd that go, man?
Oh, man, you know what? That was a blessing, bro. I was very thankful for that to happen. You know what I mean? The Suns contacted me last year, and they were like, hey, we already got one collab with you. Can we get another one? And we winded up doing it. So we can work it out and make, you know, just, you know, support the cultura. And it's dope that we do it in front of, you know, thousands of people, and the Suns have millions of followers. And for them to lift me up like that, it's truly a blessing to be able to support who we are as individuals. And like for us, bro, like where we all come from, to know we came from the dirt, to be able to be, you know, on that level, to dealing with corporate sponsorships.
Hell yeah.
And, you know what I mean? And, you know, somebody we grew up being a part of with the Suns and the legacy of the Phoenix Suns, with going back to the, you know, the Kevin Johnsons and the Charles Barkleys and the Dan Marleys and the Tom Chambers, the old school vatos.
The Madhouse on the McDowell.
Yeah, Madhouse on McDowell, bro. I used to go to the games there, bro, when they had all those stuffed animals, like all the elks and everything in the Coliseum. I used to be there, bro, doing that. So, you know what I mean? It's a blessing to be able to work with them, and I'm glad to have continued support with those guys. And, you know, they reach out, and the Suns are great to work with, and the new management, everybody they're working with. I appreciate what you guys do for me and the culture. And them even bringing me on the floor, bro. Nobody got to go on the floor. Everybody got broadcasted from their seats, and they took me on the floor to do it, bro. So I got to throw shirts on the floor, on the court. They made me sign a waiver, but I got to
What do you mean you threw the shirts? Like, with the gorilla throwing them out there?
No, the gorilla kind of posted up with me, and we started throwing shirts on
That's
the floor.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, he was there, bro, and it was cool, bro. It was dope. Thank you for bringing that up, bro. I appreciate it.
Homie. Adam was out there with the Phoenix Monkey, and I go, the Phoenix Monkey, the gorilla. Yeah. And then I seen you out there on the court, and I was like, this is dope, man. I was glad you got to participate in that, man.
Yeah.
Somebody from the neighborhood got to participate in all that.
Man, thank you, bro. I appreciate it. It was a blessing. It was truly a blessing.
Homie.
Yes, sir.
A-Bomb.
Yes, sir.
So it was a blessing for the Suns to call you out and make you presentable, but tell us, what's that feeling? What's that feeling like when you go out there on the court? Because I've seen you do it with the D-backs. And now with the Suns, what's that feeling? How's it hit you?
It's a little overwhelming when you get out there, because it's just like, you can't see it in the crowd, but you know there's Chicano support in there. Because when I walk through the games and you see all the Chicanos wearing their jerseys and everybody's wearing the shirts that I've done and everything, it's a good feeling, bro. It's a blessing to be able to have that kind of, you know, enjoyment. Like, it's gratification on a personal level. Like, nobody can feel like you feel when you're the one that produced that. So it's good, man. And this is like all glory be to God that, you know what I mean, I get these opportunities, and it's just like thankful to share them, and even sharing them with you guys again, man, like the brothers, the brother lovers, you know, back here, you know what I mean, the sexy brothers. So it's just good to have that, you know, and even you bringing it up, bro, it's a good thing that you guys all recognize, and I appreciate that. Thank you so much.
Hell yeah, man.
Well, hey, you know what, right now there's a lot of brothers here, but I think me and my brother, we're the classiest bros here right now. But hey, we'll leave it at that.
You.
Go ahead.
I might agree with you if my little brother wasn't here, because he's just as classy. He should have been sitting back there with you.
But bring him in. Bring him in. Next
all, segment, yeah. All you handsome motherfuckers, bro. I love it.
God damn it. I went from ashy to classy.
That's how we do it, bro.
So anyways, fast forward. Now we're here at Lover's Lane.
Yes, sir.
First Friday, March 1st.
I'm in love.
Lover's Lane.
2024.
A tribute to the Chicano love story.
Yes.
And not only is it just an art show and a tribute to Chicano love story, but it's an interactive type show.
Yes.
Give us a little information on that.
So I created the show just based upon the cultura, man, and how we love each other to death. Like, I grew up with seeing people, like, you know, fighting in the streets and still being together. And that's what it's about. My wife and I are celebrating 20 years this year. Thank you, Jesus. And, you know what I mean, just, and it's, if it wasn't for, you know, God in our lives and being able to put up with each other's shit, you know what I mean? It's just like, I always said, it's 80-20. I'm going to give you 80% of what you want, but you got to put up with 20% of my BS. And that's what it's about, bro. Us sticking together to show our kids that, hey, it's about, you know, loving each other unconditionally. You know what I mean? No matter what happens, you know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, circumstances are, some people go to jail, some people, you know, get locked up and do all that, and some people lose a loved one. But you know what? It's the love and the beauty that we have for each other, and that we all support each other. Now look around tonight, bro. It's a packed house. Yeah. Like, I love it, bro. Like, this is amazing.
Man.
I love it, man. I'm just so thankful that you guys came out and through the adversity you guys went through today and still came to, you know, show support, bro. And even Vince out here, man. And I'm going to continue to show love, bro, because, you know what I mean? If it wasn't for you guys supporting what I do and us supporting each other, bro, that's the biggest thing we can do, because we grew up with a bunch of hate in our body. And then we overcame that, bro. Our generation chose to overcome. And that's what it's about, bro, that we continue to teach our kids to overcome these trials and tribulations and love each other regardless of whatever you go through, man. And you know what I mean? George, bro, I love you like a brother, bro, for everything we've been through. Chris, me and you have always been cool. We've always loved each other and always respected one another. And to be here in this car with you guys today, it's a fucking milestone for me.
Speaking of the car right now, we're in the homie's car. Sophisticated Fuse in the house.
Yes, they're sir. Sophisticated Fuse.
Carlos.
Hey, you know what's crazy about this car? When I first started doing graffiti, the very first time I started doing graffiti, the first time when I, after my eye injury, and this was back in 2015, I said, hey man, I'm gonna do a mural for the homies from Blockstar, but I want a lowrider there. And this is the car that came out.
And here it is,
and
again.
It's in my video, bro, and it's crazy that they were there in 2015 with me at the house pulling up. I got to ride off in it, and you see the video. It's the first video I have on YouTube.
You're rolling down Central.
No, this is the one we did in the neighborhood, bro.
Okay,
so yeah, but
right, dude, yeah,
super thankful for the homeboy bringing out. What's the homie's name? It's your
Carlos.
It's your primo, right?
Carlos.
Your primo Carlos, bro.
He's a brother. He's a bro.
We're looking out. Carlos, what's up, bro? I'm seeing you ride right now. I love it.
Yeah,
my lady in the back seat with me.
Thank you for coming through with it, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hey,
him and his wife.
Look at the homeboys
out
here.
Wife's sister.
Oh, man. We got some people on the streets.
Hey, everybody. The streets are
Lockstar's
here.
Lockstar's in the house.
Lockstar's in the house, bro. We're
Lockstar's
doing
it. Lockstar's in the house.
So tell me a little bit about what's going on in here, the art show. Give me a little insight.
So the art show is based, I got 20 vatos and 20 rucas. The object of the art show is to look at all the pictures. And you want to choose her vato. So I have a form you fill out, and the form you fill out is basically choosing the guy she was with. I've had over 3,000 entries. I've did it in LA, San Diego twice, and Pomona, and I did it in Arizona 5 times. And I'm gonna tell you right now, nobody's got it right. The most anybody's got was 5 couples right. So the odds are crazy. It's in the millions, but whatever. It's just like the participation that people want to come and try to guess these people. And you can look at the tattoos. It just gives people something to look at. You know, look at the artwork a little deeper.
Bigger picture.
Yes, the bigger picture. Look at the eyes. Look at the tattoos. Look at what they're wearing. Like, put it all together and see if you can guess the vato. You know?
Homie, tell me this. When you go in there and somebody picks a vato and his old lady on either side, is it their interpretation of the love? Or do you have a certain, this girl goes with this guy? Or the way I look at it is like, man, that girl shouldn't be with that guy. Right. The only reason why she's with that vato is because he has feria. He's a feito, you know, he's feito and shit like that. But they make it work.
That's what it's about, bro. You know what? That's why I chose to name none of the participants. Like, none of the paintings are named. They're numbered 0 through, you know, to 20. So it's because of the fact that I got so much feedback from the show, like, oh, this looks like my tío, looks like my cousin, this is my compa, this is the homie from the hood. So I didn't want to take that away from anybody. It's just like number 01 or 002. So you guys can name them. I'm like, you guys are the ones that build this show. This show is here for the cultura, bro, for everybody to come out and have the, and reminisce about the good times they had with their loved ones, and come out, bring your lady, love one another, and just be a big part of what we're doing. And look at the homeboy Vince. I love you, Vince, for coming out, bro, even though whatever happened, bro. Thank you so much. I just want to say that since you're right here in the window. Can I get a large fries and 2 chocolate shakes?
Yeah, like we're
I feel
Sonic.
Like I'm at Sonic right now.
Oh, life.
You ain't got no roller skates on, though, bro. But yeah, well, that's what the show's about. The show's about love and familia and, you know, la cultura and everybody coming together like they are here tonight. So it's an awesome feeling, bro. Thank you for everybody for coming out.
It looks like you got a lot of your family members here too, man.
Yeah, family, friends, bro. I got my brothers, my, you know, my cousins, my in-laws, everybody else, man. It's like, that's what we do. We support each other, bro. And that's what it's about. Like, even with you, I see your family out here. I see your lady. I see all the friends and family. So, you know, I mean, that's what this event's about, bro. Bringing everybody together so we can enjoy and have a good time and a positive, you know, impact on the community. Just let everybody know that, hey, we can get along and have fun.
Hey, man, we're going to have to make you a permanent fixture here at Suniva Lifestyles What's Up, because,
bro,
man, you've been on here for a while, but let me tell you, nobody's getting tired of it, man. You're doing a great job.
And man, I
every
appreciate
time, man,
that.
You're doing great things, man.
Man, I love it, bro, and I thank you guys, and I would love to be a part of anything you guys are doing, bro. I support everybody who's doing positive things in the community, and what you guys are doing is bringing light to a lot of people's, you know, what they've been through in life, and being able to portray better involvement and better, you know, how to act better in better situations. Like when we had the judge out here, I love hearing him talk, because you know what, he's on another level, just like we're on another level. So it's just great to, what you guys are doing for the community, and you know, I'll always be a part of whenever you just call me, bro. I'm there. You right already on. Know.
Hell yeah.
Thank same you very us, much, man.
Same thing with us. When yes. we talked about this about a month ago, right?
Yep.
We talked about it, and then boom, it just happened, right? You and I were just talking about
That's how the Lord works.
You were out here hitting up the wall out here, putting up the invitation, and I came through, and you're like, yeah, you're going to park right here. You're going to park right there. We'll set up. We'll do it inside the ride, and boom, here we are.
Exactly. Here we are, bro. It everything transpired. You know why? Because we believe in each other.
Yeah.
That's what we got to do, bro. We got to keep believing each other, and I think we're going to do great things together. So thank you again, man. I know we want to get on to the next people. Hey, I got some great people here to interview. There's some heavy hitters here tonight. Yeah. Let me tell you.
Bring
in the art community, I got my homeboys that are coming from New York. There's so many people here tonight. Bro, I got professional boxers in the house. I got all kinds of stuff. So
let's bring them on.
I'm going to point some people out to you, and then we're just going to, you guys go, and I know you guys got a list of people you guys can get everybody, so I'll bring a couple people around, but let's definitely talk about that, man. Well, I just want to say thank you again to the podcast and everything you guys are doing, man. And George, I told you, you've always been a great inspiration to me, man, throughout my life. We've always got along. Chris, too, man. Me and you always had our relationship. And everybody, Vince and the whole crew, bro. Timmy, man, wherever you at, brother, I hope you're getting better. Jeff over there in Venice, thank you for representing the shirt. And you know what I mean? And Greg and Vince and everybody, bro. Thank you very much. I appreciate you guys coming out tonight.
Lover's Lane in the house.
Lover's Lane, let me give a shout out real quick. You said it. You mentioned it, Timmy. He's over there at the hospital. He's healing up. He's doing all right, everybody.
Yeah.
No worries about it, but he'll be back on.
Praying for you, Timmy.
Strong and ever.
Timmy's strong.
And Timmy's other strong. Than that, hey, man. Hey, thank you for inviting us out here. And
getting weighed down.
There's a hooker.
Hell yeah.
Right
How
on.
Much?
Thank you.
We're at 12 minutes, but we can cut whenever.
So okay, we're good.
Okay. So if you want to swap out more often, we can do whatever.
Okay.
Yeah.
Other than that, we're going to call it. We're going to take a little break. Adam's going to point out a few people to bring in, and then we'll go from there.
Yes.
This is Suniva Lifestyles.
Thank you, everybody.
What's
God happening? Bless.
Let's go.
What's happening?
What's happening, man?
The Mañana Rideshare, Suniva Lifestyles, presents What's Happening. We picked up another rider. Goes by the name of Brenda. Brenda, what brings you out tonight?
What's up? Coming out tonight to support Adam, A-Bomb, obviously. We love this, the culture. We're in a kart club, Slow Lane.
Slow Lane, okay.
Yes. Born and raised Arizona.
You're an Arizona girl.
Phoenix, yes.
Okay, and you're from the east side.
Phoenix?
All day, yes.
Phoenix in the house.
Yes.
Always.
So, where'd you go to school at?
Went to Herrera Elementary and then North High School after.
So you went to North, okay. All right. That was our first win when I was a freshman playing football. We beat North.
Oh, the Mustangs? Oh.
Yeah.
All right, all right.
Yeah.
We beat them on every sport.
This is true. So, what do you think about all this atmosphere? What do you think about Adam's Lover's Lane, the art show, all that?
Oh, my God. We love this. We love it. Everything about it. The cars, the art, the people, the community just coming together, and just having all sides of different towns coming together. I think it's awesome.
That's great. Have you been in there to take a look at the art?
We sure did.
Did you make your choices?
I matched up my vatos with some good-ass homegirls.
Now, do you think you made some good choices there?
I think I did.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, let me give you a little hint. There's one guy in there. He went on with all them rucas that are in there.
I was thinking that.
He did.
I was like, I think a few of these guys have been with more than one of the chicks.
Usually we're like that.
West side, east side, north side, south side. Bring them on.
No discrimination in the Chicano love.
No.
So you're coming from a car club, right?
Yes.
What are you guys rolling?
64. We have ours is over there, the green one. 64 Impala.
Is it convertible?
It's convertible.
Right. Right on. Hell yeah.
That's what we be cruising.
And that's your old man's?
Yes.
And his name?
Gabriel Fuentes.
Okay. Yes. And I heard you're recently engaged.
Yes, we are.
Yeah? So when's the date?
No date plan yet. We're waiting. We're working on that.
All right. All right.
There's we'll always sure to invite us so we get the podcast over there too. That'd be fun, right?
That'd be awesome, actually.
Yeah.
Don't ever hate on a backyard boogie type of wedding either.
We're actually considering that.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah. Make it like a barbecue. Kind of everybody bring your own beer.
There you go. Hell yeah. Yeah, because that's basically what weddings are.
Yeah.
It's free stuff for people. And you gotta put out all this food and drinks. You gotta provide the DJ, the music, the hall from the dance too. And what do you get? You just get a ring and you get married. You get to go home with the guy you've been kicking it with forever.
Oh, it's good memories, man. It's good memories. What is it? Food, beer, drugs.
Yeah,
oh, now never mind.
It comes out of my pocket.
It does.
But I have a big ass family. So
that's good. See, there it is.
Right on.
Right on.
We're going to go on a bomb-ass honeymoon is the plan. So we'll see.
Right on. Hell yeah. You have any thoughts on where you might go?
No, not yet.
I got a homeboy in Italy right now. He'll probably tell you where all the spots are.
That's
in Italy. Hell yeah.
We got some things up in the air. We're thinking about it.
Hell yeah. So what else, man? What else you got going?
What else we got going? Nothing else, really. Just enjoying life. We're empty nesters. Our kids are all in their 20s. So they're all moved out of the house. So.
Oh, there you go. Enjoying life now.
Yes.
It's my turn, huh? Yes. Elbow room now.
So, homegirl, growing up in Phoenix, what are your memories of cruising back in the day?
Oh, my God.
Or anything like that. What are your memories, good memories of that?
Cruising South Central.
South Central.
Yeah, that was it for us.
That was dope. That was real dope.
Yeah. 90s. Man. That was good times. Right
so did you cruise with your girlfriends? Or you cruise with some dudes or what?
Oh, my God. No, we're cruising with our girlfriends. Usually our girlfriends, mom's cars.
Hell yeah.
There it is.
Oh, because we're too young.
You remember.
Uh-huh. Scoot over.
Hanging out the window like some fools.
No.
Yeah.
But, it was a good time.
Uh-huh. Didn't TLC have a song like that? Hanging out the side of the car? No stragglers or whatever?
Something like that. That was what we remember. It was South Central cruising.
Right on.
Yeah.
Right on.
Is there anything you want to promote? Anything you'd like to say? Anything?
No. Just keep on being cool, being nice to each other. Keep supporting your local businesses and small businesses. That's what we do. No, really. Just keep living, enjoy life, and.
Support
A Bomb. And support A Bomb, of course.
Lover's Lane.
Yes, support A Bomb. We love you, A Bomb. Thank you.
Right on.
Right on. Hey, well, Brenda, thank you. Thank you for sitting in here with us.
Yes, I know. Thank you. This was different.
A little different, right?
It was. It really was. It's kind of cool, though. Yeah.
The same, but different.
Yeah, I know. Sorry, I was a little nervous, but.
No, that's okay. That's all right.
Shell shock. She got shell shock.
I know.
My brother knows your old man, and, we were good, right?
Yeah, everybody was good. Guys, right. Respectable.
Yeah.
Man. Yes.
Yeah.
Girl,
We're the classiest brothers.
You guys
here.
Are. You really are.
We're trying to be.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Hey, well, thank
this
you.
Was, this was fun.
We went from thanks. Nasty to classy.
I think your stop's right here, so nothing more to say. Thank you.
Right on, yeah. Thank you.
Right, and we're back. And when Mañana, my name right here, just picked up another rider. Goes by the name of Sammy. Sammy, what's up, man? Welcome to the podcast.
Say what's up.
Thank you guys, man. Thank you for having me. Yeah, my name's Sam Gomez, born and raised Phoenix. Grew up mainly on the west side, went to Carhaden.
Hell yeah.
And been living in South Phoenix now for the last about 10, 12 years.
Okay.
And cultivating some things out there.
That's what's up. Yeah, I'm in the backseat right here. What's up? Did you get Mr. Phoenix? What's good?
How'd you get back there?
I got picked up last minute.
Oh, shoot, hitchhiker. Oh, man.
Exactly. Just got out of wrestling practice. That's it.
Oh, no wonder it smells.
Yeah.
It smells like onions.
It's my ringworm.
I know. I was like, man, what's that smell? Man, it smells like, smells funny.
It smells funky. Nah. It's dope, Sam, that we have you in here, man. Just kind of wanted to see what's up with you and, you know, what's good. I know you got your art collab. You got a lot of projects and, you know, some things have life as far as like what happened, you know, came through and kind of just altered, you know, some things. But you're still going, huh?
Yeah, man. Thank God. Like, so yeah, a little bit what I do. I do a lot of advocacy through arts, culture, and design. And it's something that's probably just been, I think, you know, just from coming from the subculture of like hip hop in the 90s.
Yes, sir.
You know, it's kind of like that was our university of like how we expressed ourselves.
Of course.
How we used it as, you know, maybe for like to heal ourselves or therapy, anger management. You know what I mean? I grew up as a popper. B-boy doing graffiti, and I think just like as I grew older and just honoring and just like valuing the arts and how it's helped me and guide me and to this day, you know what I mean, I think for all of us, you know what I mean, we all do something artistically to express ourselves or something that we need to do to just get by, you know what I mean. Some people golf, some people like to play football, and some people like to like still do graffiti
for sure,
you know, b-boying or painting,
right,
poetry and whatnot. But yeah, so I just feel fortunate that I get to do this as a living with the Sagrado out in South Phoenix.
Yeah, say it one more time. The Sagrado. That's what it is,
so
right?
So the Sagrado, for those, you know, Sagrado means the sacred in Spanish.
Yes, sir.
So, you know what I mean? And I think, you know, like just having things and being able to do things. And I think, you know, art and life is sacred in itself. So it was just a name when I was trying to come up with the gallery name. I just kind of felt like it resonated to what I wanted to do out of there, and it really has become kind of like a mantra, you know what I mean. It's a spiritual space. We use the space for community. We also there's other groups from indigenous backgrounds that use it for ceremony. So it's being used to its purpose and to its name, you know. To the Sagrado,
you know. And it's funny when you say that too, like as far as like where we grew up, you know, went to Carhaden or whatever, and like West Side stuff in the 90s, early 90s for George over here. He's a little bit older than us. Actually, you are too. Actually, I graduated in 98. What year did you graduate?
Man, I was supposed to graduate. I was supposed to graduate in 93.
Okay.
But that was like the beginning or the prime.
Yes.
When like all the gangs and like.
It was. I mean, it was
like
tag.
Like, you know, I hung out. Like, I grew up I grew up in Mini Park. And then I, you know, like when we had homies, you know, tag banging, we were tagging at that time, you know, automatically. Like, if you, wherever you grew up, even if you weren't like a gangster, but if you were tagging or doing anything, you were still, you know, affiliated
to
that area. So like growing up in that era, man, and like, and I remember a One Nation Underground.
There, you know, shout out.
You know what I mean? I remember, you know, so just like growing up and being inspired by like, just like hip hop, you know what I mean? Yeah. And like all like the things that I grew up with. And I tell people like, man, there's so much stuff that I remember going to Silver Fox at West Hill. That's where I started like becoming a popper. Like,
got you.
Seeing like the battles after everybody got out of the movies at West Hill Theater. Yeah. And I think that's like, it's from 10 years old, you know, in the scene.
Bro, and that's crazy because when you said like the therapy part too, like we didn't realize it maybe at the time, But it was just something creative that we just enjoyed and like just kind of fell into because we just like almost like fell in love. You know what I'm saying? Like it was like the part of the culture of like b-boying or DJing or maybe even MCing for George, you know, stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's just like just kind of fell into the and fell in love with. But nowadays, you're right. It's like a form of therapy. It's a form of like working through whatever life it is and it being creative and then expressing yourself and then moving forward, right?
Right.
Moving the culture forward.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because not everybody gangbang. You know what I'm saying? Not everybody was like banging whatever and not everybody was like that part of the scene. But at the same time, we were having fun.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It was like the joy of like being a child and the joy of like kind of traversing your way through gangs and traversing your way through like a creative aspect of it instead of like going in a dark way. You know what I'm saying?
And it was all the era before social media.
Yes, sir.
So it was very like, I want to say that nothing's real now, but back then it was raw.
Damn.
And it was just because we didn't have like social media to get influence. We had like magazines and there was like videos, MTV and all kinds of stuff like that. But other than that, like it was just different. And I think there's a resonant, it's still, like there's the seeds from that era on the spiritual aspect of what we did in the streets and how we did culture. It's been very influential even up to this day.
Oh, no
doubt. As you see, like there's a lot of influence that are from the 90s. Everybody talks about the 90s. Like the 90s are the new 1960s.
Yeah, for sure.
But for the new generation. And it's, and it's cool to see that. You know what I mean?
No, it is.
That's being honored.
Yes,
so,
it is.
So we got a couple minutes here left, Sam. Tell me this. What brings you out to the Lover's Lane, A-Bomb's art show tonight?
Oh, man. Well, one, man, you know, A-Bomb's one of those artists that growing up, you know, he was the flyer king. You know, everybody had A-Bomb making flyers for him getting flyers from him. And then just like from when they were, you know, Boondocks and they were doing
Kiko
like,
copies? Kiko
yeah,
copies?
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like that whole era. So I just remember him. And it's just like, you know, when you got like people you look up to, and people who inspired you, like, you know, A-Bomb's always, you know, been there. And then just, you know, seeing him, like, maybe we got working together like 12 years ago and he started getting back into art again and stuff. So just seeing the evolution and being able to support each other for the things that we love to do. So, like, this is beautiful, man. You know, like, you guys being out here, like, this is dope. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right for sure. No, that is good. I mean, like, he's turning a true professional.
Oh, yeah.
Right? True professional of his craft.
And so, bringing people together and like bringing the Chicano culture together in a very like,
yes.
in a very like, this is beautiful.
Yes,
you know
it
what
is.
I mean? Like,
yes, it is.
And seeing old heads and people that you have around, it's like a reunion.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's like, that's how I can feel. It's like a reunion because I've seen people that I haven't seen for a long time. You're like, damn, like,
you're
I
right.
haven't seen you for 20 years.
Oh,
you know?
Geez.
But so you got anything to promote? Anything to promote real quick?
I would just say, you know, keep a lookout, thesagrado.org. Follow us on the Sagrado Instagram. We got some shows coming up. We got some workshops. So just follow us on Instagram, and that'll kind of keep you updated on what we got going on.
Yes,
hey,
sir.
Well, man, well, thank you. Thank you for coming through. Thank you for taking the ride.
Yes, and
with
you,
bro. Lifestyles. And with that, we're going to take a little break. All right, here we go. Mañana Rideshare. Just picked up a couple of other vatos that were on the right there on the curb. And we welcome Czar.
What's up?
And David.
Dave Miranda, how you doing?
Hell yeah, man. Welcome, man. So what brings you guys out to the Lover's Lane art show here tonight?
Oh, man, we're here to support anything to do with the graffiti or the street movement and the lowrider culture. We're down. The Cholo culture. We're all about it. You know, it's all about supporting each other.
Right, hell yeah.
Why don't you introduce yourself, too?
Well, Triple OG.
Yeah, they call me the Triple.
Let the people know.
OG stands for old guy, right?
Yeah, just like me, man. Just like me.
I'm a New York City graffiti writer from the 70s. I started in 1977. SAR, TMB, the Master Blasters. It's my crew. The crew was started in 1975 by some
Holy
legends.
Holy shit.
Is the Wiz was one of the founding members, Cisco, and Kaz, unfortunately, Is and Kaz are no longer with us. But I maintain the crew, and I incorporate new talent, and we still keep it true to the trains to this day. You know, 47 years later, I'm still here.
Hell yeah.
You know, cancer tried to take me out, but fuck it, I'm still here.
Fuck cancer.
Absolutely.
I can drop the kind of language, but if I can't curse, I can't talk. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
right.
That's what I said. Fuck cancer.
All right, that's what exactly. I'm talking about.
So, and I would have never guessed you were from New York.
No, you can't. Listen, when I open my mouth, they go, where you from? I've been out here 8 years. They're like, yo, where you from?
Right.
It's all love, bro. It's good. It's good. You know, all my people out here have embraced me. And
hell yeah.
I've been fortunate to find a family out here in Arizona, the way the cultural experience out here and how it's embraced.
Hell yeah.
And graffiti is a way of life here still. And it brings me back to my roots, and I love it.
You know, I'm an old school graffiti artist myself, man. So I understand where you're coming from.
Absolutely.
I understand everything you're doing, and I truly understand how you keep going with it.
It's who we are. It's like I try to explain that to people. Like, you know, when are you gonna stop? And like when the fucking wheels fall off.
Right.
You know, it's when I stop breathing. It's who I am. It's what I do.
Right, understandable.
Absolutely. And you know, if I had to make my living as an artist, I don't think I could do it. I don't think I could deal with it. You know, my art was for free. It was in your face, if you liked it or not. Going 50 miles an hour, here I am.
Hell yeah.
And it was the voice of the fucking ghetto.
Sure.
Let's say it like it is.
Sure.
It's the only art in the history of art created by children. Woo. Passed on from generation
to generation. I never heard it like that, but I think you're right.
Yep.
Think about that. Think about that for a second. What artwork was ever created by children? And the vocation was passed on from big kid to little kid, big gang member to young gang member. And crews.
Exactly.
And crews were family. And, you know, wasn't like I'm just putting up a crew name. People like, yo, Sark, can I get down to TMB? We got to paint together. You got to be with me.
Sure.
You know, guys from Europe, can I put up TMB? Nah.
Sorry. No, yeah, right.
No.
Right.
Crew's about family.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I got a brother-in-law out there, man. He's still doing the same thing. He's about my age, little older cat, you know, but almost going to turn 52. And, he can't get it out of him. You know, he loves to still go mm-hmm. out there. And
I'm going to be 60, bro. So. Like I said, I'm in it to, you know.
To the grave.
I'm in it for the long run, you know.
Hell
what I'm
yeah, right. Hell yeah. And he's not lying about it starting as kids, because tell him how old you were, my man, when you first started.
Yeah, I was 12 years old.
12.
Look at that.
And I grew up, my block, I had Satch from the Master Blasters and Psych. They were writers before me, and they were the ones yep. that taught me the shit. So, you know, they broke me in and took me under their wing, and here we are. But
right.
like anybody that ever wrote graffiti, you know, there's some people that are high and mighty and they made it in the world and they made it to the galleries. But you wouldn't have done this unless you were a fan. We were all fans. We looked
sure.
at it and said, oh shit, I want to do that. How do they do it? I remember jumping on the tracks, touching the train, going, how do you do that beautiful shit with spray paint?
Yeah.
Right,
I gotta step up my game, you know? I could tell you one of the exact moments was a Don One. He was one of the baddest writers of the 70s. There's a new book that's out. You can get it on Amazon about his life story. D-O-N.
Okay.
And it was the Mafia Crew. Master's Administration for Incredible Artists.
Nice.
And he was one of the baddest riders of my day. And I touched the train. I was like, he drew like the Ghost Rider on a motorcycle. This was 1976 he did it. I was 77. Man. I was a kid looking at it. Like, you could do that with spray paint. But like, we were all fans. That's why
sure.
we do it. You know?
Right.
And I'm still a fan. And you know what? I'm still looking at stuff out there, and I'm still amazed at what guys can do with the can. I'm still amazed.
You know what? I appreciate, like, my man Dave Miranda here. He has a podcast called Just Give Me Five.
Yeah, he does.
And he did an interview with me, and he came back. He did a really great job with it, the way he edited, the way he interviewed me, and the way he let me just roll. And it became really important in my life, because I got a lot of feedback from the guys that brought me into this game.
Sure.
Right,
and said,
right.
Yo, I saw it, man. It was true to life. I could listen to you all day.
Yeah.
They need to do another episode or whatever. But, like, more important than being a writer, like, I like to think of myself as, like, preserving the history, you know? And on my Instagram is sar.tmb, saw the master blast, sar.tmb. I blog, and I try to commemorate the people that ain't here no more.
Sure.
That influenced a million writers, and they're gone, like Dondi and Is the Wiz, you know. They're no longer with us.
Right.
You know, Tracy went 68. He actually coined the words Wild Style. He made the Wild Style movie. I have my Wild Style membership card. That's almost 40 years old.
No shit.
You know, yeah, man.
Like,
shit's heavy, I'm telling you.
They made a movie about it. called Wild Style. You know, he didn't make 5 cents from it. You know? I can say to you people out there, if you want graffiti artwork, go to the source. Go to the artists themselves.
Yeah.
Don't wait for people to die. Like,
right.
I see Tracy's paintings go thousands of dollars. You know what I mean? Is the Wiz stuff thousands of dollars. Last night I had to slap somebody. He was selling Is the Wiz photographs on eBay. I told him that fucking photo was stolen. Satch took that picture in the M Yard. I have a copy of that picture. And then, boom, he took it down.
Sure.
My boy Spine, he saw it and he was like, yo, Saw, check this out. I went right at him. He was like, boom, took it down. He right knew on. Who I was. Right on. Said, he said, oh, shit. Can't lie to this guy. He knows. I was there.
Right.
Tell that shit to somebody else.
Exactly.
You know what I love about what you do, bombing still on trains? And I don't think a lot of people understand this, and I'm trying to get them to understand this, is when you bomb on a train, that motherfucker's going across country.
Absolutely.
And everybody's...
Rolling canvas.
It's a rolling canvas. Yeah. I love that.
And if you like it or not, when we were kids, when we did it, if you like it or not, it was in your face on Monday morning. You're getting the train to go to work, and bam, there I was. The ghetto kid, the faceless kid, the kid that you wouldn't even look at in the street, now he's in your face.
Exactly.
Beautiful.
Nobody knows who Charlie is, but the whole world knows who Sar is. How you like me now. Right?
That's what's up.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
Hell yeah. So when you did an interview with this guy,
yes.
What came about with that?
Let Dave introduce himself. Again.
Yeah, absolutely. So my name is Dave Miranda. I'm the host of the Just Give Me 5 show. Yes. Arizona's own, born and raised. Designed the show to highlight a lot of the, I guess you could say, the quote-unquote unsung heroes of the valley, of the hometown. It's a lot. It's homegrown. So but it's beyond as well. You know what I'm saying? We've had legends out of here as well. Obviously, speaking in which, right? But a lot of it was to shine light on everybody that I felt paved the way for a lot of individuals that just kind of just sometimes get kind of like swept under the rug, kind of forgotten about.
Right.
But you wouldn't be here if it weren't for some of these individuals.
Oh, yeah. Most definitely.
I always say that, like, I post an old picture of an OG that was before me, and it'd be an ugly piece, and they're like, what is that? And they'll get like 3 likes, and I'm like, without him, there's no me. Without me, there's no you.
Exactly.
That's
amen.
The evolution.
Amen. Yep. Yep.
It's the evolution. You got to respect the guy that did it before you.
Yes. Absolutely.
Sure.
Because you looked up to him, and he kept it going.
Yeah.
Yep.
I mean?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. You have to respect where it came from, man. Yeah,
that's what I like about his show, too. Like, he always gives people their flowers and gives them their shine that they
deserve.
Hell yeah. While they're still here.
Like
don't be that asshole that shows up to the funeral, right? Give it to them right here. You know what I'm saying?
Don't cry in my grave.
Right. Right.
Give me that pound right now.
Exactly. Exactly.
Right now.
Exactly.
Oh, yeah. Well,
so we had George? so we had an amazing time, man. You know what I mean? It was beautiful. I also have a radio show at KDIF. Shout out to my brother Franco, 602. You know, we have a show over there. So Just Give Me 5 Radio, we actually filmed Sar over there at KDIF at the location.
I painted the wall there too. There's a couple of my pieces.
Yeah, he's
still
got
there.
Pieces
hell yeah.
there as well.
We gotta take a look at that.
It just felt right. You know what I mean? And it was just an amazing time, man. You know, getting this gentleman to tell his story, get some hidden gems. You know what I'm saying? And you know, because if you follow him on Instagram, a lot of it all is him displaying his art. Yeah. So when you get a chance to put a face behind the art and hear the man talk, is beautiful. So we were able to make that happen.
No, and I really appreciate that, man. I really appreciate that you showcase guys like this, showcase artists, showcase guys that don't really get the recognition.
Absolutely.
You know, you're giving them, like you said, you're giving them their flowers.
Right, while they can still smell them.
While they're here.
Right. Yeah.
And that's great, man. And that's what we're trying to do. That's what we're trying to do with this.
Absolutely.
Give everybody the little...
What I always tell everybody, too, like you say you're an artist or whatever. Yeah, graffiti is an art. It's an art created by children, like we spoke of. But, like, I always feel like I was a writer. Like, my artwork may sell all over the world. I've been in galleries all over the fucking planet, right? Didn't go to my head. I know the only reason that shit is selling is because I'm Saw, not because I'm a good artist.
It's a name.
If I didn't wreck havoc on 1,000 trains, my shit would be worthless.
It's the name.
Say that shit, baby.
But that's the way I feel, bro.
Yeah.
People are like, oh, I love your art. What art? I'm a writer.
Yeah.
So tell me about this. You're a writer, but I love your ride out there. What you got out there? Tell me what you got.
Talk about that.
Listen, look at this. Cadillac for life, man.
Cadillac. That's my brother, man. My brother loves Cadillac,
Cadillac
too.
Cadillac for life.
Yeah,
see,
man.
When I was a kid, I couldn't afford a Cadillac.
Right.
And that was like a symbol that you either retired or arrived in life.
Right.
So I remember as a kid, I was about 18 years old. I had my girlfriend in the car, and it was an 84 Eldorado Baritz convertible for sale in the parking lot.
Yeah.
And I jumped out of the car. I ran over to the fence and looked at it. It was the first one I ever seen up close and personal. And I told my girl, I said, look at this thing. Isn't it beautiful? She says, you're never going to be able to afford that. Get back in the car.
Oh, man.
So I said, what did you say? I got in the car. And she goes, where are we going? I says, home. Dropped it right off. That was that.
Last time you saw her?
And you know what? I own that fucking car. For
hell yeah.
Years. There we go.
Hell yeah.
I ended up buying that car. I had it for 17 years. And then the Arizona Attorney General said I owed him back taxes. So I told him they wanted $12,000. So I said, come. I said, you got my name? Yeah. You got my address? Yeah. Come and get me. I'd rather do six months than give you my car, man.
Bafango!
I'll figure it out. You know what I mean?
So, oh, shit. But that car was I have about 15 years. It's been a long-term project. You know, it's a 79 Coupe de Ville. Yeah. I had the upholstery done in New York by the company's name is Phoenix Upholstery.
Oh, wow.
He's in Long Island. Yeah. The guy's badass. I did red piping, matched the red land out. You know what I'm saying?
Wait, in Long Island, Phoenix Upholstery.
Phoenix Upholstery, for real.
Ain't that something?
For real.
That's how you know we made a mark.
Fruition.
Here, right?
That was a fruition.
So I did that. I did the interior. And then the crowning jewel was I wanted to put a set of rims on it that belonged on that car. And I found this guy in California. I couldn't believe it. He had Craig Star wires brand new in the box.
Wow.
And I was like, I don't care how much you want for him. I want him.
Push the button.
So you know, that's the crowning jewel of my
life. Yeah, they look nice, man. They fit that ride perfect.
They belong on it. You know?
Here we were just pulling up to hang out and ended up being part of the show.
Hell yeah.
When I pulled up, I said, let me just stop in and see Rob and see if he's all right. I said, leave it right here. Everyone will enjoy it. Leave it right here.
Oh, yeah, man.
So, boys, I got a minute left.
You got anything
to promote?
Oh, man, just go ahead, sir.
No, just if you want to follow me and learn a little bit about the history of graffiti and some of the New York roots, even though I've been in Phoenix and I got some roots here now for the last 8 years. I painted with a lot of guys out here and a lot of OGs out here.
Sure.
But if you want to follow my Instagram, it's sar.tmb.
We'll put that up.
Yep, just give me 5 on YouTube, at Mr. Miranda on Instagram.
All right. And this is Enrico in the back as well.
That sure
He's still
Enrico
back there.
In the house.
Other than that, hey, man, thank you. Much love, both of you guys. Thank you for stopping in with us. Thank you for jumping in the ride. I think this is your stop. Let's get off. Let's ride.
Have a good night.
All right.
God bless, brother.
All right. Here we go again. What's Happening Podcast. Mañana rideshare. We picked up Rob here. We picked up Rob. Somehow, way, he jumped in the ride, and here we go. Hey, Rob, thanks for coming through.
What's up, George? Thank you for having me, bro.
Right
appreciate
on,
you.
Man. So, Rob, tell me this.
What's up?
How are you involved with all this, Lever's Lane? How'd you get involved with that A-bomb here?
I own Grand Art House, and I'm the curator over here at Ceseo Gallery. And I've been running that for about 7 years now, just kind of putting on shows for the community. From a wide spectrum of different genres of art, performance. Grand Art House is a co-working art studio. We got artists, we got Lalo, Madman, Spock,
yeah.
We got a bunch of
hell
them
yeah. Yeah.
Top-notch talent in there, you know?
Yeah,
so
fucking
mind,
People's
so
Champs,
so
People's
so
Champs.
How do you pronounce it again?
Ceseo.
Ceseo, okay.
I didn't come up with that name.
All right.
It's Oasis spelled backwards because this is the Oasis on Grand Apartment Complex.
Well, you know, Suniva is Avenue spelled backwards over here.
There you go.
So all we're doing is going backwards here. We're back in time. He just got in the ride right now. He said, sucks getting old. No, it doesn't.
I'm probably going to need a forklift to get me out of here. You know that, right?
Yeah, that's how I feel, man, getting in this ride. No, man. So how'd you hook up with Adam, A-Bomb here?
Me and Abe, I'm go back a little bit. Basically, from I'm writing graffiti scene, common circles. We've been on a couple walls together, or within the same vicinity, and just the stars just aligned. And he was in here maybe a couple months ago, and I approached him like, "Hey, what, you know, how about you? You want to do a show? I got spots open," and here we are, man. I mean, he crushed it. I mean, this turnout is just phenomenal.
Hell yeah. I'm looking at all the people here.
And oh, it's
everybody's
phenomenal.
Giving love, and it's a great turnout. We've been just talking about it right now outside of when we took a little break right here, and I'm like, wow, man, really great turnout, Adam. I like what you're doing. I like that you're pulling everybody together. Now, Rob, tell me this, too. Are you from Arizona? Are you an Arizonan?
Nah. I think my accent kind of gave that away. I moved out here 2008 from New York.
You're a New Yorker, too? We just had a New Yorker.
Oh, Sar?
Yeah.
Once you get him talking, man, he's a walking encyclopedia.
Oh, he kept going, man, but it was great oh, yeah. shit he had, man.
He's great got great stuff, shit, man. Yeah.
So you're from New York, huh?
Yes. Actually, Sar, he was one of my writers that I looked up to growing up. He's like a generation or two before me.
Okay.
So growing up on Long Island, like taking the trains into Manhattan, seeing him getting up all over the place, like that kind of inspired me, you know, to write myself. I've been writing since 89, and he's a whole decade ahead of me, you know.
So you're part of the crew back then?
Oh yeah. TWA, BTW, a bunch of other crews. I mean, I've been writing since I was 13 years old, you know?
All right. Sheesh. So what brings you out here to Arizona?
I followed my daughter out here after a divorce. Her mother got remarried, had another kid, yada, yada, yada. You know, they wanted to move out here to be closer to her parents. So I followed suit. And, you know, that was, 16 years ago. She's about to graduate NAU with a 4.0.
Damn, nice.
So, super proud.
Very proud.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I did something right.
No, man. You're doing a lot of things right,
she
man.
She did all
it
the work,
great,
but I'll take all the credit, you know?
Hey, but it was fun making her.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. You kidding?
Yeah, for sure.
I'm pretty sure I got like a kid in Puerto Rico somewhere.
You know? But you're throwing down too. Like you know, yeah. You're connecting people over here in the community too as well.
Yeah.
Like, you know, bringing artists like A-Bomb, like you said, like
absolutely.
For a few years.
When I first moved out here, I didn't really know anybody.
Yes.
And, you know, through the writing community and, like, just, it's, like, slowly, it's organically grown.
Yes.
I wasn't trying to posture, trying to, you know.
That's the best way.
You know. And with having the studio and the galleries, that was a common connector for a lot of artists.
Okay.
A lot of people that I've come in contact with. So there were people that advocated for me as I was kind of getting into the scene here. And I'm just kind of paying it forward, you know, doing the same, just kind of putting people on, you know.
Damn, that's what's up. Yeah, paying it forward. Like, I mean, especially with the artist community, I feel like if you're legit and you're real, like a real person, that's what you do, right?
You know, genuine people are hard to come by.
No doubt.
And when you do come across people that are, like, you know, real,
yeah.
You know, real recognizes real.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's one of those things that, you know, if you're trying to... trying to fake it, people are gonna see right through you.
No shit.
So I didn't want to force anything. I'm all about things happen organically.
Yeah.
And you know,
look at everybody right now.
I feel like this is home now.
Yeesh.
You know, I go back to New York and within like a day, it's like, I mean, get me the fuck out of here.
Damn, that's what's up.
It's too many people. The traffic, but fuck that.
You know what? I got a partner at work. He says the same thing. He's an older cat. He's from New York. And he's out here in Arizona. Every time he goes back, he says, nope, take me back. I want to go back. I have no reason to be back there. His parents still live there. But he's like, I need to go back to Arizona.
Within 15 minutes of landing in JFK, walking out with people flipping each other off, like, huh? It's just, no. But, you know, my accent has definitely been watered down since moving out here.
Okay.
But
okay.
You get me back east around my friends, and I'm dropping the F-bomb every other word and talking with my hands and, you know.
No fucking way.
Forget about it, right?
Yeah, that's what's dope. No, man, that's dope.
You've been a curator of the Ciseo.
Yeah.
How long you been a curator here?
7 years. Okay. I've had Grand Art House 8, and from the success of that, they asked me to take over the gallery operations here. So between Grand Art House, Seseo, I also run another gallery called Mood Room, which is an art link gallery. And they're a nonprofit that that helps a lot of the art community here as well.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah.
What else you got, Enrique?
I mean that's good, bro. I mean I like what you're doing.
Thank you, bro.
I like the vibe. I mean we were born and raised here. So a lot of times like when we saw like First Friday grow to from like nothing, obviously participated in it as well.
Oh yeah.
And then to now what it is now, which I mean it is First Friday, but at the same time we're a little bit broken away from it. But at the same time, like Grand and Roosevelt, this has grown to a thing where we didn't see before.
What I think Grand Avenue is how Roosevelt used to be.
Go ahead.
It was all raw. Like now it's all gentrified. It basically turned into Mill Avenue.
Go ahead. Yes.
A bunch of jerk off college kids.
Go ahead. Yes.
You know. But out here, it's more community. It's
yes,
more like
yes.
It's more where the real people are.
No, yeah.
You know, and when you get that genuine, you know, feel that flavor, it's just you can't beat it.
No, I know.
You know,
it was there. It was there. I would say like in the 90s, because one of my buddies had like his grandfather had a poultry shop just like right down the street, right? And we would go there every now and then it died out, right? The recession hit, and like you know things kind of died a little bit, and you know it was struggling a little bit there, and then it is revived. You know, it's here now, and we're like a revived Grand Avenue type scene, which is dope. And the culture is being recognized. You know what I mean? The art is being recognized.
And with the whole pandemic and shit, I'm just happy to still be here.
Damn.
Because there's a lot of my homies that just they went under. A lot of artists I know that you know gave up the game to go back to you know full time job.
It was tough time.
Yeah. I mean, I actually quit my full time job 2 years ago to do this full time. So I'm happier, but making less money.
It's a risk.
Less stressed out.
It's a risk.
Right, it's a risk.
But your health, like mental health, may be better now.
With my daughter graduating college, it's like I can take more risks.
Yeah.
It's not like I have to sit here and, you know, worry about covering this child support payment or alimony and shit like that. But it's
and you're old enough to figure it out too.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
That's why I feel sometimes too.
I'm pushing 50, and like my I don't give a fuck meter is just getting the needle is just going up and up.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
You're a New Yorker. Isn't that like your
birthright?
That's
in my DNA.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. 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 I mean it's like I give a fuck.
But it's starting to get
maybe at one point you did. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, you did. Yeah, you did.
I should say I don't give a fuck what people think about me.
No, for sure. I get you.
Back in the day, I was more concerned, like, will they like me? Will I fit in with it? Like, now it's just like, just be yourself and fucking keep it real.
And you're confident what you're doing.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised I'm doing this well in this interview because I historically suck in interviews.
No, you're doing great, man.
No, you're doing great, bro.
No, you're doing
for sure.
Great. So one quick last question about this. So Adam's stuff in there.
Mm-hmm.
Did you go in and check it out, and were you able to pick out who you thought?
Oh, no. I tried to get him to tell me what the answers were, and he's like, nah, bro, I ain't telling you. He's like, I can't put two and two together. I could say either one of them can be with either one of them at any get. You know, it's like.
That's what I say.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Right. That guy's got money, and, hey, that's what she went after.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro.
So real quick too, as well, we're gonna end it right here. You got anything you want to promote? Anything you want to say? Anything last? Any shows coming up that you want to promote?
I mean, I do shows once a month, man. Okay. So I got a constant turnaround of shows that I'm taking down, putting up.
Yeah.
Seseo, Grand Avenue.
Hell yeah.
Even Grand Art House. We got so many dope artists in there.
Right.
Yes.
I want to make this like a go-to destination on First Fridays. Get away from all that craziness on Roosevelt.
Sure.
Because this is where it's at.
Mission accomplished,
bro. This is how it used to be like before all that gentrification and shit, you know?
Well, right I think on, you already
man.
Got it.
Well, right on, Rob. Hey, right. man, thank you for joining us, man. Thank you for jumping
Rob.
In the ride.
George, man, I know
it was a little struggle to get in here because we're all the way low. But that's...
I got Tony right here. He's gonna help me out of this.
That's the way get in we right cruise, you know. We gotta go low and slow.
For real,
you know what I mean? But hey, again, thank you for hosting this.
Thank you.
And hopefully we're back and we'll do this again.
Hell yeah, man! Is this right, your man. Ride?
No, I. Yes, it is.
I was gonna thank say you. Pretty damn sweet.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank bro. You guys. Appreciate
thank
it,
you,
man.
Thank you.
Thank you, Doc.
Right on, man. Thank you.
Hell yeah.
Thank you,
man.
Thank you.
Suniva Lifestyles, What's Happening Podcast. The Mañana Ride Share has picked
what's up
another straggler out there. G, welcome G to the ride. Hey, G, what's going on, man?
Yeah, it's good to be here.
Right on,
man. It's comfortable
man.
In here.
Hell yeah, man. Yeah, yeah, get a load off your feet, huh?
That's right.
Out there walking around. Hey, so tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would, you know?
Yeah, so I've been in Phoenix for about 10 years now. Just moved back. In September.
Where are you originally from?
I'm from all over the world. I've lived in China for a long time.
Okay.
Damn.
38
countries. I can tell.
You can tell. You see it, huh? Yeah, yeah. People always think I'm Chinese, but yeah. I'm not quiet. So.
I knew you were a Chino.
Yeah, yeah, there we go. There we go. That's why I'm here tonight. That's it.
Yeah, so what's up?
That's
okay.
it.
Okay.
But, yeah, man. So back in Phoenix, really passionate about people with disabilities, and so we're trying to do something to care for people with disabilities.
Well, stay where your business is.
Yeah, so I'm with Rise Coffee. We're a nonprofit coffee shop. We're going to be in Central Phoenix, but our goal is to empower people with disabilities. So we're trying to provide jobs for people with disabilities. So our coffee shop is going to be run by the best people in the world.
Damn, that's what's up.
Where is that coffee shop at?
Yeah, so currently we're located at a gym called Ability 360. If you guys haven't been to Ability 360 yet, it's a gym for people with disabilities. So everything in that gym is adaptive, meaning people in wheelchairs can use any machines.
Damn.
It's one of the coolest spots around. And this weekend, actually, we're helping host a wheelchair youth basketball tournament. So they wanted me to holler about that because we're pumped for that.
How'd you get involved with all this?
Yeah, I mean, man, I love sharing that story. I started taking care of a dude that had a traumatic brain injury. So he was 12 years old and was in a car and one day just got hit. And then for the rest of his life, he's in a wheelchair. And what I saw from this guy, his name was Tanner, was that he was one of the most positive people I've ever met.
Like, damn.
When he would interact with people, he would just show them so much love, kind of like what we got going on here tonight.
Yeah.
But like, when people would see him, they would like be like, feel sorry for him almost. But he didn't feel sorry for himself, man. He was able to just move around in this chair and just like bless people through that.
It's like optimistic.
Yeah, for real, for real.
Even in the situation.
Yeah, man. Because I can't imagine that. Like one day just being able to walk, playing right. sports, and then next day you're just in a wheelchair for the rest of your life.
Oh my god.
But I meet people like that every single day through this kind of line
no
of work.
No doubt.
And these people inspire me to like
I
not
bet.
complain.
I bet.
Because man, when you see that, you're like, man, I got legs that work like properly and I'm able to move around.
Yeah,
and so
yes sir.
We got a lot to be thankful for.
Yeah.
Right on, man. Hell yeah. So what brings you out here tonight? I mean, did you check out the artwork and stuff from A-Bomb?
Checked out the artwork, heard about this event, wanted to come through, and then a lot of people here have like kids that have people with disabilities.
Right.
And so like that's how we got connected. Okay. And so a lot of the artists, their kids have disabilities, and so
damn.
We have a natural connection right there.
Hell yeah.
Man, that's dope.
Yeah.
Hell I'm yeah, pumped. Real dope, man.
That's kind of the first time I've ever heard, like, you know, as far as like, you know, giving yourself to something, you know, so sorry, something like you said, with someone with disabilities or like someone less fortunate or maybe an accident or something like something like a tragedy. Right?
Yeah.
You know, so it's really dope that you're here. It's really dope that you're like representing that and helping those people as well. I mean, it takes a lot.
Yeah, and we're going to be located in Central Phoenix because people with disabilities in Central Phoenix have less opportunities than they do in the suburbs.
Yes, sir.
And so we really want to try to change that. Like,
you know,
man.
I never thought about that, but I think you're right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's just so many more things out in the suburbs for people with disabilities, but in the inner city, not so much. And so we want to change that.
Ooh.
And we want to provide good coffee, man. Our coffee comes straight from Honduras, so it's going to be good. Yeah. That's I went there about a month ago.
I was going to ask you that. Did you go
over
there?
Yeah, okay. I did. We're supporting it.
Check out the coffee over there?
Yeah, our coffee comes straight from an orphanage down there. And so the coffee proceeds are going to go to, like, building up this orphanage. So it's cool on a lot of levels. But
hey, that's Georgie. That's where Gustavo was from, my homie.
Yeah.
I grew up. He was from Honduras. Yeah. Honduras.
Beautiful, man.
That's my best friend when I was a little kid.
Yeah. One plug for Honduras, man. Like, it's required that you say hi to people down there, and I love that kind of culture.
Yeah,
like,
that's what's up.
You got at least wave.
Yes.
So we need that here in the States a little bit more, man.
Yeah, you do.
At least what's
say
up.
Hi.
Yeah, why not?
Good day.
It sounds like you're helping out on both ends. I mean, over there in Honduras, and then you're bringing the love over here, and you're helping out over here, man.
That's the dream. Hit them on both sides. The world needs some love, and so does Phoenix. So we're here for that.
Right on,
more
man.
Of
hey,
it.
Man.
More of it.
Yeah.
Much appreciated what you're doing there, man.
Yeah.
So what else you got, man? What else you got going? Anything else, man, you want to promote? Anything like that?
Nah, man. Just really, like, that's what I'm passionate
that's
about
what
right
it
now,
is,
man.
Yeah.
And that's what I wanted to share about today is, like, man, if you want to have a positive experience in your life, interact with people with disabilities because they see the world as I think we should. Like, they don't judge people. Like, they'd come to an event like this and they wouldn't be judging.
Tolerance.
They would see, they'd
tolerance.
See everybody as the same.
Yeah.
They're not, like, worried about what people think.
Right.
Like, most human beings are all worried about
that's what the world needs more
think.
Is tolerance, bro.
Yeah.
Like, we just need to tolerate people. Like, who cares?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Tolerance and also, like, not worrying about what people think so
no
much.
No doubt.
Like, just be yourself.
No doubt.
Like, my homies would all be out dancing right here.
Yeah.
They'd be totally sober, just dancing.
Yeah. That's dope.
Because, like, they just don't care.
Yeah,
they
of course.
Hear music,
why
they're
should
ready
they?
To boogie.
Yeah.
And most of us aren't that way, but I'm trying to be more like them. So,
damn,
right on, man.
That's what it's
hey,
about.
Man.
Good
that
shit, man.
Good, man. That's
good,
really
shit.
Good shit. Hey, totally good shit, man.
Yeah.
I love what you're doing, man.
Come on.
Once again, tell me about your coffee shop.
Yeah, it's called Rise Coffee. We don't have a physical location yet, but we're located at Ability 360 Gym right by the airport. So come check us out. This weekend, we'll be at a wheelchair youth basketball tournament.
Any social media?
So, risecoffee.az. RIScoffee.az. So come check
follow,
us out.
Follow.
We would love for you to follow us, man. Our first employee's name is Joshua, and everybody needs a Joshua in their life. Like, I don't want to ruin the surprise, but he's one of the most amazing human beings ever.
Amazing.
Right on, man.
Yeah, check him out.
Very inspiring, man. You're very inspiring, man. Thank you very much. Hey, man. Hey, well, thanks.
Yeah, and thanks for letting me be in the coolest car I've ever been in.
Right on, man.
I needed that.
Right on, man. So, hey, man, thanks for joining us.
Are we going for a ride after this or what?
Yeah, we can, man.
All right.
Thanks for letting us into your story, man, and let us know what you do and this and that. I loved it, man.
Yeah, thank you, man. Thank you.
Come on. And I'm going to call you, since you're a Chino, Bruce G.
There we go.
Hey.
I like that.
Right on, man. So
thank you, guys.
Here's your stop. We're getting off.
Yeah.
Thank you again for what's happening.
Thanks, brother.
Appreciate you, guys.
Thanks, brother.
Thank you.
I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I just want a little bit of love and loving yourself because this event is about you guys. It's about the cultura coming together and loving and respecting each other and showing everybody what it's like to have a weekend and love one another and to have, you know, just the love to show our community that we can give back and show our kids and our future generations this is how we need to be. There ain't gonna be no more drama. We all grew up in gangbang and all that dumb shit we all grew up in. But I'm glad we're here now showing love to everybody.
What's happening, podcast has just picked up a couple of other stragglers from the corner right over there at Circle K. Boom.
Get a thirst buster.
Right there in the neighborhood right there. Let's go.
Hell yeah.
I got an old school partner right here. We went to Butler School. We went to Isaac Junior High School. We fucked around at Falcon Park, and we ended up at Carl Hayden. This is my old school partner right now, Hector Primero.
What's up,
man? Welcome to the podcast, man. Thanks for taking a ride with us.
Thank you, brother. We skated together, too.
That's what's up.
That's true. Remember, we used to take the ramps over there to Butler, in the basketball courts.
Oh, yeah.
Hell yeah. That was dope,
man. That was dope, man. That was fun.
Who else we got back here?
Tony, dog.
Right on, man. Hey, thanks for joining the podcast back here, man. Hey, don't step on the seats.
Yeah.
So what's up, Hector? What brings you out to Lever's Lane, Adam Bomb's art show here?
I got to support the homie, man. I've known him, what, 40 years now? I've known you 40 years.
Right?
40 damn. Plus years. Not even 40 years, but 40 plus years, man. But
First grade.
First grade. Yeah, man. Cougars, right? That's why we were all taking Butler Bulldogs.
We're the Bulldogs. Yeah,
sure. But no, man, I've known Adam for a long time. I see Adam, you know, we still catch up. We catch up at some Suns games. We catch up off of Roosevelt and doing stuff. And, you know, that's my homie, man. I've known him forever. And, I got to show him love, man. I'm proud of him. I'm proud of everything he does. And I've been following his career the whole time, just like he follows me, man. So, you know, and it's just, you know, a couple kids out of the West Side,
that's what's
man.
Cool,
you know,
man.
So it's like we always got to be there for each other, man. So, you know, here I am.
You know, every night I'm watching a Suns game, and I see this little head behind the basket right there, and I'm like, that's my dog right there.
Yeah,
that's
man.
My dog back sitting the right Suns there, courtside. I'm like, God damn it,
time.
Real quick. I always want you to trip LeBron when he goes by, man. Because you're sitting right there. You're sitting right there. Man, trip him, man.
I know, man. I know. I hate the Lakers still, man. I'm all about the Suns, man. I hate the Lakers, man. I can't stand them, man. But
so what you been up to, man? What you been up to, man? I see you all. Like I said, I see you at the Suns game. I see you
traveling.
Doing some,
he's traveling.
NFL
doing
stuff.
Yeah, traveling.
Tell me what you been up to lately.
So my life's been kind of interesting, man. You know, for the longest time, you know, I did corporate America. You know, when I first got out of college, I eventually ended up moving over to help my parents with their business. You know, they had their party rental business that they've, you know, that they've had for years. You guys have rented stuff from them. Everybody on the West Side has rented stuff from them for sure. Primero Fiesta Rentals, PF Rentals, off of 19th Avenue in Van Buren. Yeah, they still there too. Mom and Dad, my brother, still running it.
Yes,
but
right
I was
on,
there
man.
For years, man. And then eventually, man, I got an opportunity to go work on a reality show of all things. So I took advantage of it, went in there, busted my butt. At 36 years old, man, I was 36. I'm 51 now, so I was 36 years old, and I was working as a production assistant. But I went in there, busted my butt, and they loved what I did. And at the end of the show, they asked me, you know, hey, would you come out to L.A. and work? And I was like, yeah, man. And they're like, all right, you know, we'll call you. A month later, I was out there working in L.A., working on a show for MTV. And my career just took off, man, and it's never stopped. And I went from reality shows. I ended up doing some TV shows. Ended up doing some movies. I did Fast and the Furious 5. That was like the biggest movie I worked on. And from there, I ended up in Hawaii, man. A Mexican in Hawaii. Hanging out there, working for Roseanne Barr. Yeah, man, I was out there working. It was crazy, man.
He must be a skinny Samoan.
You know, yeah, it was crazy, though. But I went from there, went back to L.A., and then decided to come back to Phoenix, come back home. And, you know, I brought everything that I learned with me back to Phoenix and started doing commercials here. And then I got into sports entertainment. And I started working for NFL Films, man. I'm actually a contract worker, so I'm not technically employed by them, but I am a contract worker, and I've been working for them for 10 years now. And started doing basically just running cards, man, from the field, from the cameraman to somebody else that downloads all the media. And that was with the Cardinals. Did really good. They love me. Did a Super Bowl with them that year. That was 2015. And then the very next year, man, I ended up doing a show called All or Nothing with the Arizona Cardinals that ended up on Amazon Prime.
Yes, it did.
And we ended up winning an
That's
Emmy.
That's what's up. That's what's
so,
up.
So believe it or not, my ass won an Emmy, man. Like a Mexican from Carl Hayden High School won an Emmy.
Take me back. Wait, you won an Emmy?
I won a sports Emmy, man.
That's what's up, dog.
That's crazy. It was one of those things that I don't even know how it happened, but I did, man. And, you know, and I got to thank like all the people that I work with NFL Films. Like they've helped me, they've groomed me, they've showed me so many different things, man. Like they're family, man, just like you guys are. Like they helped bring me up, and you know, they've really, really pushed me forward to continue doing what I do and to spread it out for others, man. And that's what I've been doing. But yeah, man, from there it's just my career took off in sports, doing all NFL stuff, traveling all over the country, doing different shows, doing Hard Knocks, you know, for HBO, doing a Peyton Manning show, just doing like everything you can think of, you know, with NFL. And also with the Cardinals, man, like they've treated me as well. And then eventually I ended up going and I had an opportunity to work with the Phoenix Suns. A friend of mine, my friend Ben, ended up hooking me up. He was a cameraman there. Got me on as a utility, basically assisting the cameraman when he goes out onto the court.
Okay.
And we do all the in-house stuff. And, you know, I just kind of, you know, I just cable him out and cable him back in. But, man, I get to sit in the second row and watch all the superstars, man, and get paid for it.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
You know, like, that's a dream job. That is a dream job. Like, I'm a Phoenix Suns fan. Die hard. you know, and I'm like, for me to be there and see that, I'm like, I'm just a kid from the West Side, man, and to see that is crazy, you know, and I'm always like, you know, if they ever get to the championship again and I get to be there with them and they win a championship and I'm on the court, like, I'm probably going to start crying, like, literally, because I love that team that much that I don't even know if I'd be able to do my job.
But, I think a lot of us are like that, man.
Yeah,
I think a lot of us are like that with the Suns.
Yeah, and, you know, for me, I used to go to the Madhouse on McDowell, man. You remember that? You know,
we were just talking about that, remember?
Isaac, we go there.
Two for one?
Yeah, man. Remember halftime, man. Isaac be playing, Isaac Cougars be playing, you know, Borman or whatever at halftime.
Yeah, at halftime.
Well, yeah, so now I get to be a part of that, and I get
final
to see all
the final score was 3-2.
Yeah, it was. And I think Isaac lost, too. But no, man. But yeah, that's basically
what
I've been doing, man.
We never lost.
No, but I've been doing television production, commercials. I've been doing a lot of sports stuff, you know. And, you know, at 51 years old, it's just crazy, man, that, you know, my life's just been all over the place. And here I am doing something that I never dreamt that I can do, man. And I always say this. I'm like, I feel like I'm living somebody else's dream. And I say that only because I didn't know that I can dream this, that this was a possibility, because nobody ever showed me that we can do that. Figure you graduate from high school, you get a good job or something, you know,
and that's the way it's going to be.
And that's the way it's going to be. But nobody, we don't live in Hollywood, so I didn't know that, hey, I can go into, you know, doing television or doing movies, and here I am doing it, and it's just wild that I got here, and I'm thankful for it, man. You know, I thank the Lord. I thank my family, my girlfriend, my parents, all my friends, man, for always supporting me like you guys, man. You guys always support me, and I hear you guys, and I think about everybody, man.
Right on.
I'm like, you guys are there with me.
Right on, man. Hey, much appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
Hey, man, love your story, man. Love everything. Like I said, to me and this guy go back way back, man.
Yeah.
And it's great to have you in the car, and it's great to hear that you're doing great and that you are living a kid's dream, basically, you know?
Yeah,
From the barrio.
Yeah, yeah.
From our barrio.
Right on, yeah.
Like you said, we weren't supposed to be there.
Nah.
And here you are,
and here
you know?
We are, yeah.
And, you know, like I said, man, I see you, you know, I see back behind the scenes stuff that you're doing and stuff. You just told me that you're on you did a little thing with the Caballero and Christina Soy, man. That to me is like, wow.
Steve Caballero, I got a chance to work on a documentary with some friends of mine. It was Steve Caballero and Christian Hosoi. And, being around those guys, those were our heroes, you know?
Those were our heroes.
And like I was telling you earlier, I'm like, I've been around a lot of celebrities. I've been around a lot of different, you know, sports figures, huge sports figures, man.
Name
Hall
dropper.
Of Famers.
I got to mention something, though. So I'm from LA, right?
Okay.
But I always tell people, like, you know, raised as a Los Angelino, but I'm rising as a Phoenician. And I lived there more than half of my life already, so I consider myself a Phoenician.
Right on.
And one thing that, you know, Hector's talking about all the stuff he's done, but he's one big Phoenician historian, man.
Oh yeah.
And the thing about that, I don't know anyone around Phoenix as much as he's done of the history that he's have told, and I share with him, that I've studied with, you know, on my back end and share with him.
Yeah.
And he knows it all. So when it comes to like history stuff in Phoenix, besides all the stuff that he just mentioned, but even like the landmarks and all that stuff like that,
right.
Hector is the man. He knows about it.
I appreciate that, man.
Because he used to do photos with, like, you know, like he took old photos and blended with the modern times.
Sure.
Yeah, new shit. You know, that was a few years back, but he's going to make it.
You'll see some stuff coming back. Yeah, I'll be doing that again.
So for me to be like, you know, as a proud Phoenician now, you know, investing my time and my life in here and supporting the community and everything.
Right.
I respect Hector on that level, man.
I appreciate you, man. I love you too, man.
Who is this guy back here?
You got Dr. Tone.
I'm a local bus.
Yes, sir.
But, you know, before that, I used to have an Asian-American dessert shop called Snow.
Yes,
it was the first one in Central Phoenix and in downtown.
Okay, that was you.
Yeah, that was me.
All right.
So there's a mural in downtown where Cobra is. That's the only mural. There's a food dog mural on the side of High Score.
Oh, yeah.
But when I had a Snow shop, I had a local graffiti writer paint a mural, a food dog mural. And what a food dog represents is a guardian dog.
But
it was the first Asian mural actually in downtown Phoenix.
Oh, shit.
But to me, it was a call of, like, the guard dog is still there. It's still next door. It's still on the wall.
Right.
The representation of it is that it's a garden for, you know, downtown Phoenix, dog. You know what I mean, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's still there, dog.
You do graffiti, though, too, right?
Yeah, I used to write back there before Snow and Autumn. You know, hey, I grew up around Chicanos in L.A., too, right? So, like, where I grew up in L.A. was Asian Latinos. The same thing.
Mexican, like, man. He's Mexican, too.
The 90s.
Yeah.
So you're from L.A. You're from L.A., turned Phoenician. turned Chicano now.
Chino Chicano. But
he's
the thing
tamales,
is, still grow up in LA,
language,
like, you know, if you grew up in the hood, you're mixed with everyone else who was still coming up. So, you know, I used to go to every white group was a Monte, you know, Monte, Rosemead, you know, like, you know, like yeah. the Swan Beats, everything, dog. We get the buckle belts and all everything, dog. Just the whole works. But the same time is that, you know, because we're all like, you know, I'm 42 already, right? So, like, growing around the culture and us being around like this, to me, this is normal for me, right?
Hell
you know what I mean?
Yep.
And it's the, like, everyone here is on the older level, respect level, and all that stuff like that. So I feel like that's the vibe.
Spreading
that
love.
You know, spreading love, and now we're older, and we just want to like represent for our culture. But you know what? I can't forget the catura from the Chicano culture I grew up with. You know,
right on.
You know, in the neighborhood I grew up, because I'm a refugee. I'm from Thailand.
Okay.
You know, so I'm a refugee, right? And like, obviously, when you come from Southeast Asia, they're gonna put you in the neighborhood where you know where all the low, you know where all like people of color are. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you just like from the Mexican American culture on the West Coast to here in Phoenix, it's just that. Our cultures and traditions are the same.
They are.
Familia, you know, share respect levels.
Right.
You know, sharing, you know, our food together and everything like that. Honestly, Asian, Latino, Mexican food is the best blend, dog. You know what I'm saying?
Give me a little insight of what Local Buzz is.
Local Buzz is about, it's about highlighting all these things that are happening in local communities.
Okay.
Not just the food stuff, but everything from arts and culture to events to our communities.
Really quick, it's an app.
Yeah, it's a platform.
It's an app you can download.
Yeah, it's a platform. Internet company that started right here in Phoenix.
Yes.
And now we're in Chicago and Austin.
Okay.
And so forth in our cities, right?
We'll put it up on the podcast.
But one of those things that I want to show, I'm proving that Phoenix has a lot of amazing things that come out of the city.
Oh, hell yeah, we do.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. And that if a startup can make it out of Phoenix, they can make it out of where else. Because usually other startup tech companies come from other cities. And I'm trying to make it rise. I'm doing it to make it rise from
right here.
From Phoenix.
The Buzz.
Yeah.
We used to have a restaurant like that south of the border. Remember something?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Fusion
like that.
Fusion.
Oh, yeah.
Chino Bandito, dog.
Chino Bandito.
Let's go south of the border right there.
Oh, yeah. South of the border.
35th and Thomas.
It's better when you say it.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
So, man, hey, thanks, Matt, for jumping in the ride with us.
Thank you guys, man. Appreciate it, man.
And, you know, I know Hector paid you to say all that stuff about him.
I'll Venmo you, man. I'll Venmo you. I got you. Apple Pay.
Yeah. It's great to hear you guys are doing great, man.
Yes.
Doing good stuff, especially with the community.
Yeah.
Especially what you're doing in your own lives, man. It's great to hear. Yeah. It's great to hear old school partners, new school partners doing great stuff in the community,
right on,
man.
Hell yeah.
Especially here in Phoenix, man.
Oh, yeah.
Love it, man.
Oh, yeah.
I can't stress enough.
Yeah.
I think that's great shit, man. And like you said, Phoenix has got a lot to offer.
Yeah.
And people need to understand it. And I think you're doing that on the next level.
Exactly.
You're doing that with your app.
Yep.
And you know what? And we're trying to do that a little bit here with what we're doing here on our podcast.
It's all about expression, dog. You know,
and,
expression.
And it sounds great, man. I really appreciate it, man.
And you know, I got to say, too, man, as you know, I've been watching you guys' interviews. I've been watching everything you've been doing for the last few months. And, you know, I appreciate what you guys are doing. I appreciate that you're giving everybody this platform to come on here and say what they have to say, because otherwise maybe, you know, they wouldn't have that.
Right.
So with everything you guys are doing, I'm proud of you guys, man. Like,
right on,
it means
man.
A lot
Thank
to
you.
Me to see y'all doing that. You know, it's great to see, you know, Vince's kids out here working, doing stuff. Like, got to give them what, you know, got to give them props.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
It's cheap labor.
Cheap labor. No, seriously, though, man. But, like, you guys are doing some big things, too. And you guys are highlighting Arizona and all the good stuff about Phoenix. Because a lot of times, man, you know, I look all across the country, we get a bad rap in Arizona because of our politics, because of all the crap that goes on. But it's like, nah, man. Like, and that's what I was trying to do with True Phoenix back in the day in my photos and stuff, is that, you know, it's like there's a lot of good stuff happening here, man.
Yep,
but we always have to play like little brother to Los Angeles. And it's like, nah, man, like we got a culture here.
Yep.
We got a lot of history here, man. And I know people come from all over the place, but we've been here for a long time and we're still growing. And there's big things happening, man. And sometimes, you know, other people in different states might not see that, but it's like it's up to us to put it out there and let them people know 100%, that we're here, man.
100%.
You know, we are here. We're doing some big things, man.
Yeah.
And they better get ready for it.
Well said, man.
Well said.
Yeah,
you know it.
Sure.
So with that being said, man, hey, you got anything you guys want to plug?
Nah, man, that's it, man. If you haven't checked out Local Buzz yet, www.localbuzz.co is here to represent for you guys and represent what Phoenix is all about, too. You know what I mean?
Yep. Hector, you got anything to plug?
As far as for me plugging, man, you know what? Not so much plugging, but more like, you know what? I grew up on the west side. I grew up downtown, and then I moved to the west side, and that's when I met you, man. I was in the third grade, you know. And
third grade, that's right.
Third grade, man. Third grade, when I moved, man. When I moved down to Roosevelt. But it's like, I always try to tell people, it's like, it don't matter where you came from, man. Like, I remember thinking, like, I don't know what I'm going to do if I'll ever get a chance to do anything. And I couldn't, you know, I couldn't even dream about what I'm doing now. But no matter what you dream of, like, go out and grab it. Yeah. Don't be afraid to do it. Don't be afraid to fail. Right. Fail, learn from it, and keep going, man. And it's like, you can do whatever you want. You know, we're brown. You know, some of us are black. Some of us are white. Yeah. Some of us are, you know, yellow, whatever. It doesn't matter what color, man. Like, you do whatever you dream of doing, whatever you want to do, man, and don't let anybody stop you. Okay. That's
exactly,
it, man.
Consistency is key. And as long as you have purpose,
thank you.
Drive it forward, man.
Exactly. Yeah. And you know what? And respect everybody, man. And show empathy to everybody. Because we're all just here for a little bit, man.
Yeah. Appreciate that, man.
Hell
appreciate
yeah.
that, man.
Now, you know, you're 51 already, dog. I said I'm still 40.
I'm getting old. But I'm still a bad man.
he's like 42.
Enrico,
42.
You got anything to say? You got anything to plug, Enrico?
No, I'm good, man. I mean, I love you guys. I mean,
love you too,
like
man.
Like I said, bro, like
Mr. Phoenix,
just pushing this shit for Phoenix. You know what I'm saying? Like, I go by Mr. Phoenix, but like, you know, I was named that shit by my friends and my homies back in the day. But it's because I like push my friends. You know what I'm saying? I just like love the community. I love my downtown. I love my West Side shit. I love people. I'm not gonna lie, it sounds corny as fuck, but I love fucking people. So just keep doing it. Just keep doing it. You know what I'm saying? And just be real too. Be a real human being. Be a nice person. Be a good person. Say what's up. Say hi. Give them, you know, say good morning. You know, whatever. But other than that, that's it. I'm good.
Right on, man. Hey, well, guys, thank you for jumping in the ride with us.
Appreciate you, man.
Hell yeah. Hell
right
yeah,
on, bro. Man. Taking the ride.
Yes, sir.
I should be keeping my eyes on the road right here. But
why
again,
are you driving?
I know.
Driving?
Don't worry about it.
You want a drink?
Don't worry about it. Don't show that. Hey, thank you very much. Hey, thank you. Hey, for coming through.
You know what's up, man.
Enrico, thank you for sitting in.
Oh, of course, man.
Thank you for coming through. Hey, this is Suniva Lifestyles presents What's Happening. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and follow us. Oh, yeah, and don't forget to comment on that motherfucker as well.
Say what's up.
Hey, man, this is Lover's Lane. A
shout
true experience.
Adam.
Shout out to Adam. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Adam
Bomb. Again,
yeah.
What's Happening?
What's
Let's
happening?
Go.
Simone.
This is how we do it on the avenue.
Shots fired.